The York Revolution is on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Here he swings and hammers it. Watch this one go. It's a game winner.
Revs Baseball on WOYK is brought to you by People's Bank, Wellspan Sports Medicine, Maple Donuts, Broadway Transmission, Flying Feet, Dasher Investment Services, York Mitsubishi, Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, York Dental Sleep Therapy, Mad Dash, Pennsylvania Lottery, Neighborhood Family Markets, PSECU, Kona Ice, Smith, Mayer and Little, Commonwealth Connections Academy, Downtown Inc., and United Way of York County.
Swing and a deep drive to right field. Watch this one go. He fires. Game over. Base hit. It's a fair ball. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. He slides. He's in. Revs won it.
Now with today's York Revolution pregame show, here's Will DeBoer.
At People's Bank Park in York, Pennsylvania, it's the York Revolution and the Bridgeport Bluefish. Friday night Atlantic League baseball action is right here on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. Hello, everybody. Will DeBoer with you. Your eye in the sky in downtown York, where it is another hot night. The song of the night is Hot Blooded by Foreigner, except the thing with a temperature of 103 is the air. Not quite to that degree. It's 92 degrees as of right now, but it feels like 105. It is hot. The humidity is dome-like, but we're here to play baseball. It's just another typical August evening in South Central PA, and the Revs will try and stay hot, get hot again after falling last night to the New Britain Bees. 2-1 losers, could not complete a four-game sweep. The Revs falling to 60-43 overall, 20-13 in this second half of the 2016 season. They will face the Bridgeport Bluefish team that finds itself in second half contention. 17-16 in the second half. That's good for a game and a half back of first place in the Liberty Division. They are in second place in that division and 47-56 overall. The Revs will try and get the bats restarted. They've hit a bit of a lull over the last 2 days, scoring 3 runs in their last 2 games combined. They beat the Bees 2-0 and then lost last night 2-1. And the man hoping that the Revs can find their bat speed again tonight is the man making his 20th start of the season, the rock of the rotation, James Simmons. 9-4 with a 3.83 ERA overall. He is coming off of another quality start, a win at Southern Maryland on Sunday afternoon. Gave up 1 run on 3 hits in 6 innings of work for his 11th quality start out of 19 this season. He's made 2 starts against Bridgeport this year. The Bluefish have roughed him up a bit. No record. He's allowed 11 runs in 13 and a third innings. That's a 7.42 ERA. Last time he faced the Bluefish, he surrendered 4 solo home runs on June 17th. The Revs were able to score 6 in the bottom of the 7th and come back to win that game 6-4, but the Bluefish have teed off on Simmons like he's the Lynx at Augusta National, and he will try and shut them down and make them all look like Charles Barkley with golf clubs tonight. As for the Bridgeport Bluefish, it's the former and current Bluefish, David Kubiak. Kubiak, 27 years of age, from Riverhead, New York. His second stint of the season with the Bluefish. About 2 weeks into the season, he got by the Yankees. They assigned him to Double-A Trenton. He made 3 appearances for the Thunder before being released and returning to the Bluefish. So he'll make his 8th start and 13th appearance overall. He's 4-3 with a 3.11 ERA, coming off a loss against Long Island back on Friday evening, where he gave up 6 runs in 5 2/3 innings. The Bluefish will try and ride him back to their winning ways after having been swept by the Sugarland Skiers over a 3-game set over the earlier part of this week, including a doubleheader loss last night. We're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, I'll invite Daryl Henry into the booth, and we'll talk about, oh, who knows what. And then afterwards, it's the Broadway Transmission Manager's Report. All that and much more on this fine radio program, so thanks for joining us on your Friday night, everybody. This is the WOYK Revs Pregame Show.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at your SureSave neighborhood markets. Use your gold card every time you shop, and you automatically receive savings and rewards. And get incredible deals on the new BestJet brand products at Sauble's Markets, Wetzel's Market, and also at Nell's Market Fresh Foods. Always a hit and always great savings.
Hey, Revs fans, seasons come and go, but French fries are forever. Brickers Famous French Fries are back for their 10th season as a member of the Revs team. Come and celebrate the team's 10th anniversary with those fan favorite fries and chicken tenders. You can find them, as always, behind center field next to the playground at People's Bank Park. Call 717-792-4959 or visit online at brickersfries.com. When you want French fries, nothing is better than Brickers.
Payne doesn't take Sunday off, neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into Wellspan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
Getting pumped for another year of high school football? All this month, Sports Radio 1350 WOIK lays it all out for you in the High School Football Spotlight, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Catch a preview every day in August on Sports Radio 1350 as we break down the teams and the players of the 2016 York Adams League. Or go to WOIK1350.com to access this year's complete lineup of high school football previews. Then, this fall, every Friday night, it's the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Only here on Sports Radio 1350.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Welcome back to WOYK Revs pregame show. Revs and Bluefish set to begin their three-game series in about 10 minutes. Let's take a look around the Atlantic League. These are your weekend series. Sugar Land is in New Britain, Lancaster is on Long Island, and Southern Maryland is visiting Somerset. Your updated standings in the second half. The Sugar Land Skeeters, by virtue of their doubleheader sweep of Bridgeport yesterday and the Revs' loss, have jumped to a half game ahead of the Revs. In the second half standings, the Revs at 20-13, Sugar Land 21-13. And the Barnstormers and Blue Crabs are tied for third at 14-19 each. Over in the Liberty Division, Long Island a 1.5 game lead at 18-14 over the second place Bluefish, who we're about to see. 17-16, the Bluefish in the second half. And then third place Somerset, 17-17. New Britain in free fall, except for last night, 12-22, 7 games back of first place. And now for a preview of all we have to offer here at People's Bank Park on this fine mid-August weekend, we will turn it over to the 10-year voice of the York Revolution and advertiser supreme. This is Daryl Henry.
Well, for tonight anyway, Will, thank you. And we have a big one here tonight. The fans getting the Jeff Koons bobblehead giveaway on the way in as part of our Celebrate York series presented by Memorial Hospital. Tonight after the game, the stadium stays open for our Boy Scout groups who are here tonight, the on-field sleepover. It's not open to anybody that didn't book in advance, so I don't want to say the wrong thing there, but they will stay here tonight and camp out in the field and watch a movie on the video board. Always a great time. Tomorrow night, we'll have the Stauffer's Family Fun Fest on the Brooks Robinson Plaza beforehand, so great time for everybody on the way in. And on a Saturday night, Ross Brothers Barbecue and post-game fireworks, as always, which tomorrow is brought to you by the Lube Center. And also youth football and spirit night, so a lot of local football and cheer teams will be here, and energy will be very high, I'm sure. And then Sunday at 1 o'clock, we've got a great giveaway, the hat to the first 850 fans, the cap giveaway presented by Stambaugh Heating and Plumbing, and also the York City Little League Chopper Drop, dollar hot dogs presented by Hatfield Quality Meats, and our Sunday fun with Catch in the Field autographs and Kids Run the Bases. Tickets for the whole weekend and also now for playoffs.
Playoffs?
Sale at YorkRevolution.com, 717-801-HITS, and at the Apple Chevrolet ticket office.
Playoffs? Well, I guess we can talk about playoffs since the Revs are going to the playoffs. So thank you, Daryl, for that. We'll bring him back in just before first pitch. For now, we're going to take one more commercial break. And when we come back, it's the Broadway Transmission Manager's Report. Stick with us. This is the WOYK Revs pregame show.
At HealthSouth, rehabilitation is all we do. So it just makes sense that HealthSouth Rehabilitation Hospital of York will help you get home sooner. HealthSouth is the largest rehabilitation provider in the country. We provide 3 hours of therapy 5 days a week, frequent physician visits, and registered nurses 24/7. It's total team-based care that is squarely focused on your recovery. After an illness, injury, or surgery, choose HealthSouth, providing a higher level of care to the York community for more than 30 years. HealthSouthYork.com.
Have you got game? Do you love playing softball? If you're between the ages of 10 and 18 and want to take your softball skills to the next level with more competitive play, try out for the Lady Revs. The Lady Revs is a tournament softball organization that offers you the opportunity to play a higher caliber softball as well as to play with other players who love the game just as much as you do. The Lady Revs will be hosting tryouts in August, so if you are interested and want to take your skills to the next level, you should visit YorkYoungRevolution.com and click on the Lady Revs registration button. York Young Revolution is a 501c3 not-for-profit organization.
Hear that? It's the sound of summer. Sound nice? Call Kona Ice. We do it all. Schools, sporting events, parties, both corporate and birthday. You name it, we'll be there. We bring the party to you. If you need a little bit of fun in your life, we're the shaved ice truck for you. Oh, and we fundraise too. This summer, cool down with Kona Ice. Give us a call at 1-800-KONA-ICE or visit us online at www.kona-ice.com. Kona Ice. Flavor our world.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Fans, it's time to go inside the clubhouse for the latest on your York Revolution and tonight's matchup. It's time for the Broadway Transmission Manager's Report. Now, here's the manager of the Revs, Mark Mason.
Well, Mace, strange game last night with so few hits. Frank Gailey outstanding, and last couple of starts he's been really good, and most nights that's going to get him a win.
Oh, there's no doubt. He's had some tough luck this year. He's left the game 2-1, 2-2, a lot of one-run games when he's left. And, he pitched really, really well last night. They had two hits off him, and, one was the ball in between, in right center, and the one down the line in left field. And other than that was it. And I think Golson walked. I think that was the first run that scored. I think he walked, and he got the second base on either pass ball or stole it. I can't remember. And then the kind of in-between ball to right center was the first run, and then the second run was the fly ball down the left field line, and then the sack fly to center, and that was it. So really good job by Frank, and, he pounded the strike zone last night, I thought, and he mixed it up again with good change of speed and kept the ball down, and I thought he did a really good job. And unfortunately, last night was, just a tough offensive night for us, and we don't have many of those, but last night was one of them, and we just couldn't overcome the two runs.
Yeah, do hitters occasionally need a reminder about the approach? Was he really commanding everything, or was that a night where they kind of got out of their good approach a little bit?
I don't know. I thought we swung a little bit too early in the count. He can be a little wild too. I just thought maybe we were out of sync a little bit. We did swing at a lot of first pitches that we didn't do a whole lot with, and sometimes you get a good fastball to hit early and you miss it, or you pop it up or something like that. And I just thought we had too many first pitch outs, and we're not building a pitch count on the starter. I think he had maybe three innings in there where he threw probably no more than six or seven pitches in each inning, which obviously, I think when I looked up there, it was like the sixth inning or whatever it was, and he might have had 60 pitches at that point. So, we really weren't doing a good job, I thought, of working him over. And, but you have some nights like that, especially if you get a little frustrated, you see something that you want to swing early in the count, and I think that's what we did yesterday.
They've got Bridgeport coming in this weekend. They've been playing way better and certainly in the thick of things in the Liberty Division. What have you seen with the way they've kind of beefed up and made their transition to contention this year?
Well, to be honest with you, I thought they had one of the better offensive lineups in the league, even in the first half. I know they battled some injuries, you know, in the first half, and I think their pitching staff was kind of in flux a lot. But we went up there to start the second half, and I mean they were playing much better offensively. They definitely put the bat on the ball, and their starting pitching has gotten better. So, when you have starting pitching getting better, and they play good defense overall too, I think anyway, and they have some versatility with the players. They can move around, and they have a lot of lefty switch hitters, and it's a very formidable lineup. And in our ballpark, we're going to have to pitch really well here and against them, because they're a dangerous hitting club like we are. So we're going to have to be on our toes here the next 3 days.
Well, lastly, you've got James Simmons tonight. You've got a couple of guys in the rotation that are, working on 2-3 really good starts in a row, and he's certainly in that category.
Yeah, James for me has been one of the better, most consistent starters all year from the beginning. And I think every time these guys go out there now, they're trying to figure out a different way, because when you play teams 20 times and they might see you 3 or 4 times in that amount of time as a starting pitcher, sometimes more than that, you start to think that they have a game plan for you, so you try to game plan for that game plan, and it just, you try to reinvent yourself a little bit. I think you still pitch with your best stuff always, but maybe you throw this pitch in a certain count when you normally didn't do that before, and maybe a little element of surprise here and there, just enough to keep them, just to keep them honest as hitters. And as long as you can execute those pitches for strikes, you're fine, but it's always a command issue. As long as you can command it, you'll be fine, and hopefully we can do that again tonight.
All right, thanks a lot. Good luck.
Yep, thank you.
And here's the anthem.
Move through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Yes, it does. Fine rendition of the anthem right there. Oh, the joy is to be young and to learn all the patriotic ditties. Now let's bring you the starting lineups brought to you by Flying Feet. First, for Luis Rodriguez's Bridgeport Bluefish. Luis Hernandez, a switching shortstop, leading off. Andy Chavez in center field. Jose Cuevas at third. Sean Burroughs, recently acquired from Long Island, playing first base and batting fourth. Wellington Dotel in right. Jose Gill doing the catching. Jonathan Galvez DHing. Angelus Nina, the left fielder. And then Luis Nunez, the second baseman, for David Kubiak, the starting pitcher. As for the Revs, this is the lineup for Mace tonight. Travis Witherspoon in center field. Jared Mitchell in right. Joel Guzman DHing. Kevin Rivers back into the starting lineup after that collision on Tuesday evening. He's batting fourth and playing first base. Michael Rocket out in left. Brandon Chavez at second. Brian Pounds at third. Ryan Erie during the catching. Last time we saw him, Revs pitched a 5-hit shutout. And the batting ninth is the shortstop, Josh Wilson. For Big Game James, James Simmons making start number 20. 11 quality starts out of 19 this year. 9 wins against 4 losses, a 3.83 ERA. He is second in the league in wins. 2 back of the man the Revs will see tomorrow evening, Jonathan Alabadeo of the Bridgeport Bluefish. The Revs in their alternate blue uniforms with the name of every former Rev player on the back, and then the 10th anniversary caps. Bridgeport in their alternate uniforms as well, the teal with navy blue letters and numbers and the gray pants. And so as Luis Hernandez applies the pine tar to his bat and will eventually take a walk to the batter's box, Well, he's coming. He's coming. He's, well, actually, that's not even him. And here he comes. They got the door fixed or whatever. So he comes to the batter's box, and we will turn it over for the Dasher Investment Services first pitch to the 10-year voice of the York Revolution, doing what he was born to do and not just sell stuff. This is Daryl Henry.
Well, thank you, Will. I'm surprised the pine tar hasn't melted right off the bat. That would be gross.
Oh, just wait.
Hernandez to lead it off for Bridgeport on this steamy evening, and our Dasher Investment Services first pitch is over for a called strike, and we are underway. 6:34 our start tonight. Board says 96. Heat indexes say like 104, depending on which one you look at. Here's a foul straight back, and the count nothing and two. Hernandez hitting 292. Has a home run, 39 driven in. He's second in the league in total hits with 120. Has been the leadoff man for a pretty productive order. Two strike pitch is up high, he lays off. Revs are in those alternate navies, as Will mentioned. The Bluefish have their teal tops tonight. Navy hats with the teal brim to accent it.
A very 90s look.
Simmons kicks and delivers, and missed inside, 2-2. Working with Erie, who makes his second start, first time catching Simmons.
Erie didn't have much time to formulate a game plan with Micah Owings and company last time out.
There's a foul back to the screen, 2-2 it stays.
When I talked to him, he said he basically just went with the flow when it came to his pitchers. Had them pitch to their strengths, and well, it certainly worked. Combined five-hit shutout. Owings with those six innings being caught by Rowe, and then Nate Reed, Scott Rice, Ricardo Gomez. Just one hit combined between the three in the last three innings.
On the wind, another 2-2, and a pop-up foul, third base side. This will find the stands. Played up tonight is Brian DeBrower. He's maybe taken up temporary residence here as often as he's been here.
So that's the guy who's been sleeping under the desk back at the station, huh?
There's been a guy sleeping under the desk at the station? Wow. We learn a lot of things here.
Well, I assume it's either him or, you know, Skinny Pete.
There's a ground ball rolled right side, and Simmons will have to cover. Chavez from second has it, throws to Simmons at the bag. Rivers went for it as well, but it was a long backhand. He let Chavez take it and banked on his pitcher covering first, and Simmons did his job there. 4-1 on the hookup to start the night. The other umpires, Drew Hoagland at first base, Joe Dalbalso at third. We had him in the series at Southern Maryland last weekend. Simmons' last start was down there. He pitched very well on Sunday. Six innings, one run on three hits. No decision. Here's Andy Chavez, who takes down an inner. I'm sorry, a win. We had so many no decisions with late wins, but that was a win for him, his second straight. Won the first and last games of that road trip. 1-0, and that's over for a strike.
It was nearly a no decision for him. After he finished getting for the sixth inning, he found himself down 1-0. Revs explode for five runs in the top of the seventh, and he departs with a comfortable 5-1 lead.
Pitch here is in tight, 2-1. Chavez has been hot. Last nine games, 457. Overall, he's at 329. Simmons the pitch, and he missed a little low, 3-1. Simmons fourth in the league in innings coming in tonight. Very dependable. 3-1 and a swing and a pop fly. Pounds will turn and hustle back from third in shallow left, and it drops in the triangle. Rocket reaching to pick it up. Chavez will hold on with the bloop single. And with those three chasing it, there is not much room where that's going to fall in, but Chavez lobbed it in the perfect spot. Shallow left. Looked like Rocket may have had him play to pull it a little bit, so he had a long way to go, and it was just far enough out to get over both the heads of Pounds and Wilson. Chavez, a one-out base runner on the blue pit. And here's Jose Cuevas. Simmons out of the stretch, fires and missed down and away. Cuevas, good plate coverage and stands pretty far off the plate with slightly open stance. Batting 280, 9 home runs. Pitch to him. He swings and pops this up by the York dugout, but it'll be too far back for Rivers. It lands in the second row behind the dugout. Cuevas has hit 2 of his 9 home runs against York. Bluefish were held in check against Sugarland earlier this week. Simmons a throw to first and Chavez back. They were swept at home by the Skeeters, 3 straight losses, and in a doubleheader yesterday, losing 4-2 and 1-0. Simmons ready and delivers and missed outside, 2-1. Didn't miss by much. Simmons is asking where it missed, and I think DeBrower set away, and Simmons shook his head, no. Now the stretch, and the 2-1, swinging a foul back and out of play. Joel Guzman sneaking up behind whoever's coaching first base for them, wielding his bat like it was a playful weapon.
Well, he got excited by that new Star Wars trailer that came out during the Olympics last night. Darth Joel.
Simmons ready and fires, and a breaking ball lined off the glove of Pounds at third, and it trickles into left. Rocket will have to come in to pick up. It's a base hit. Pounds climbed the ladder but needed just another inch or two right off the very tip of the glove, and Cuevas hooks the line drive hit, first and second with one out. He came very close. And here is Sean Burroughs, who was injured just about all year with Long Island. And the Ducks traded him to Bridgeport for right-hand pitcher DJ Mitchell, who's now Long Island property. Last season, Bridgeport had sent Burroughs to Long Island for Brian Sabatella. And now Burroughs is back with Bridgeport. Pitch from Simmons to the big lefty hitter. He swings through it. No balls and a strike. Former Padres third baseman, former Little League World Series star back in the early 90s with Long Beach.
2-time champion.
Hitting 285 with Bridgeport. Pitch from Simmons, he swings and misses. Couple of fastballs. Actually 285 overall, 303 with Bridgeport, playing in his 10th game since the trade tonight. Did get in 42 games with Long Island, but we seem to always miss him. The 0-2, and a swing and a miss. 3 straight fastballs, and Simmons brought this one in on him and got him to swing through that. 2 Southern California boys squaring off, and Simmons wins the battle for out number 2.
Burroughs was behind on every one of those fastballs. Maybe it's the crushing humidity. Maybe he's still trying to work his way back from the injury that kept him out for so long. But if I'm Simmons, I'm going back to that pitch the next time he comes up.
So 2-on, 2-out. Wellington Dotel, who's moved from 3rd in their order down to 5th, will dig in. And he is out of the batter's box, and he swings and misses at the first pitch. He's got a wide open stance, and his front foot, the heel, is outside of the outer line. His right foot right on the back line but near the plate. Now he tightens it up a little. The 0-1, And he swings and loops it at second. Chavez is there. He will squeeze it. And the jam shot bloop pop-up is caught to end the inning. No runs, two hits, two left. At the end of a half, it's the Bluefish nothing. And the Revs coming up.
You hear a lot about CPAP masks these days, but here's something you don't hear much about. Over half of the people who wear a CPAP mask for sleep stop wearing it within a year. How's that working for you? Dr. Gordon Bell would like you to hear this. York Dental Sleep Therapy has dental options that can help many of those people. If you or someone you live with is struggling with sleep apnea, visit YorkSleep.com and see how Dr. Gordon Bell can help return your home to peaceful nights of deep, restful sleep. If you're groggy during the workday, if you wake up feeling exhausted, if you would like to get your nighttime sleep patterns back to a healthy state, get a confirmation from your doctor, then meet with Dr. Bell at his office on West Market Street in Hallam. He'll evaluate your symptoms and discuss which treatments would best suit your situation. Dr. Bell can restore restful sleep and get you feeling better day and night. York Dental Sleep Therapy. Call 316-1299 or visit YorkSleep.com to learn more.
Come and celebrate 10 years of York Revolution Baseball with the Celebrate York Series presented by Memorial Hospital. The series honors significant contributions from York, Pennsylvania's most notable events and favorite citizens with giveaways every Friday night home game. The series continues on Friday, September 2nd with a bobblehead giveaway of York's favorite mascot, Downtown. Visit YorkRevolution.com for more details. It's the Celebrate York Series, proudly presented by Memorial Hospital for the York Revolution's 10th anniversary season.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Now James Simmons works out of a little one-out trouble. And the Revs will face righty David Kubiak. He's ready to make his eighth start, 13th appearance. Big righty's 4-3 with a 3.12 ERA for Bridgeport. A lot of strikeouts, 54 in 52 innings, only 14 walks, and five fewer hits than innings. Opponents hitting only 240. It's been a solid arm for them. And Travis Witherspoon up first. Kubiak's first pitch of the night is a fastball down and away, just missed. For a big guy, he's got kind of a short stride. Stands angled toward his third base dugout. A 6'7 righty to the plate, and he misses in the dirt, ball two. Witherspoon coming in at 292 overall, 316 with York.
He had one of the four hits and the RBI last night.
Pitch is over for a strike, a cutter. Now we've seen him very active with his speed here recently. The wind and the 2-1, and a swing and a miss, a cutter. A couple steals a couple of nights ago. And last night, the only run batted in. The wind from Kubiak, 2-2, and a swing and a miss. And some big tilt on that hook straight into the dirt, and he got Witherspoon to chase. Well, it would appear from that first at bat that the curveball might be his strikeout pitch. That was pretty filthy. And with one down, Jared Mitchell to the plate. Mitchell at 289 with York. Held hitless last night, but went 6-for-12 the first three games of the homestand. First offering, a swing and a miss on a fastball up. The Revs' season-high tying six-game winning streak snapped last night. Two six-game streaks this year, their longest two since 2014. Pitch is dribbled foul over to Joel, who's on deck, and he lets it go right past him and into the dugout. Kubiak the wind, and the 0-2, and it cuts in tight. And Mitchell takes. Kubiak a loss his last time out. 5 2/3, 6 runs against Long Island. 6-2 loss. Now deals. And a swing and a miss. A slider this time down out of the zone. And he starts the night with back-to-back strikeouts. And Joel Guzman to the plate with 2 down. Kubiak signed by the Yankees on May 4th. Went to Double-A Trenton, but they only had him appear in 3 games. That was hardly a look as long as he would have deserved, you'd think, the way he's pitched here. And then came back, obviously. Second stint. First pitch to Joel is down and away. Guzman, 7th in the league in hitting coming in tonight. 300 on the nose. 14 homers. His 72 ribbies are 7 in front of Josh Bell. Next one, a curve, and that buckles over for a strike. The Kubiak threw that curve for a strikeout to the first hitter. This time, he throws it for a get-me-over strike. And now the 1-1, and a pop-up on the fastball. Coming back is Heel, the catcher, and he does not have room. It just got over the screen. Bounced up off the stairs behind home plate. 1-2. Kubiak from South Old New York, 26-year-old.
Yeah, I just got to interrupt you. Downtown's doing a gymnastics routine over on the third base dugout side ledge, inspired by Simone Biles and all of them.
1-2, and a foul off the net. And what's amazing with Downtown is he doesn't spend nearly the training time to get ready for his routines, and yet he pulls them off.
Well, that does not really surprise me.
Kubiak, the kick, another 1-2, and a ground ball poked toward the middle and out of the reach of Nunez at second. That'll get into center. Now a base hit, the first of the night for York. Nunez going to his right, but couldn't get down to the backhand anywhere close to low enough for that ball. And Joel, the seeing eye hit. And here's Kevin Rivers, who's back in the lineup tonight. Got blown up on that collision at first base a couple nights ago. Actually, Tuesday night, 3 nights ago. He's missed the last 2 games, but back in tonight. And overall at 267, 286 with York as Kubiak misses low and away. Got the cleanup roll tonight with Dre getting a night off. Rivers 381 at home for the Revs. And the pitch, it is just outside, a changeup. Now we've seen 4 different pitches from Kubiak already. Fastball, curve, slider, change. The 2-0, and a swing and a miss. He doubled up on the changeup, lowered it, and got Rivers to swing over it. Kubiak against York, 1 start, 1 relief outing, 8 innings, 5 runs. There's a fastball low, it's 3-1. Against York in 8 innings, he's struck out 11 and has walked only 1. He began his career in the Rays system, 36th round pick in 2011. Well, the 3-1. And it's just outside. So a walk to Rivers following Guzman's single that kept the inning alive. And first and second for Michael Rocket. Rocket, a 6-game hitting streak snapped last night, but comes in at 299, tied for 8th in the league. First pitch, a curveball, and he ducked, and it bent back for a called strike. He had given up on it and ducked while backing up. Rocket at 476 his last 11 games. Pitch is swung on and missed. A cutter from the righty. 429 the last 17 games. And 337 since June 9th. Over 2 months. The 0-2. And he checks on a slider in the dirt. Appeal to first. And they say he held 1-2. No score here in the first inning. Rocket trying to draw first blood for the Revs tonight. Kubiak, the stretch, and the 1-2. And it missed outside. Fastball at 88. Heel tried to snap it back and frame it, but DeBrower's outside corner has been pretty tight here early tonight. The 2-2. And a foul back to the net. A Rocket battling. Revs a two-out threat. Simmons stranded two after a pair of one-out singles in the top half. Revs with a two-out single and a walk here in the home half. 2-2. Curveball, a foul tip, and Heel held on to it. And Rocket claiming that it had hit the dirt first. And that's going to end the inning. Kubiak strikes out the side. DeBrower said he caught it cleanly above the dirt. No runs, one hit, two men left. We go to the second inning as Rocket is not buying it, but no score.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA certified technicians.
Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they help me with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
Savory's Funnel Cakes have brought their delicious delicacies back to People's Bank Park for the second straight year. Be sure to visit their stand on the third base concourse near Arch Street Eats as they offer both regular and pumpkin funnel cakes. Also be sure to check out Savory's Funnel Cake Facial Contest during all York Revolution home games. They offer event catering as well. Give Savory's a call at 717-271-3485. That's 717-271-3485. Savory's Funnel Cakes, York's delicious delicacy for all to enjoy.
All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
No score as we head to the second inning tonight. Former Camden River Shark Jose Heel will lead off the inning. Took over primary catching duties for Bridgeport around the midpoint of the season. First pitch from Simmons is across for a strike. He is 4-for-6 against York. The Revs had a lot of trouble getting him out in the first series of the second half in Bridgeport. There's a fastball a little low. That's the last time these teams had met. Heel in 31 games, hitting .298. A couple of home runs. 1-1, fastball missed low. Last year with Camden, he hit .242 with five homers. Apparently he was ejected last night. The 2-1, and he lines it to right field, and that'll get in for a hit in front of Mitchell. He has to play it on one bounce, a leadoff single to start the inning.
Heel, a veteran of this league, as Darryl mentioned. They've had Connor David as a backup catcher all year, but as just a rookie, it's been hard for him to get by playing time. And they've got Rosmel Perez, who's been on the suspended list for a couple of weeks.
Here's Jonathan Galvez, who DHs tonight. Here he sets up in, and Galvez bunts toward first. Rivers in, he gloves, and nobody there. It caught him by surprise. Rivers came in to glove it. And the problem, well, Simmons was caught by surprise, and he hesitated, kind of going for the ball rather than going straight to first to cover. The bunt drew him toward the ball and then couldn't get to the bag. And Chavez, not only at double play depth, but playing the right-hand hitter to pull, he had way too far to go to get over to first to cover. And it'll be a bunt hit for Galvez, a guy with some pop that you wouldn't expect to do that. First and second for Angelis Nina. And now he squares to bunt, and he sends one in the same direction. Simmons over to glove it, and he'll underhand to Chavez at the bag this time. Sacrifice is good, 1-4, and the Bluefish with some small ball to set the table here in the second inning. Second and third with one out. The K-man, Luis Nunez, rounding out their order tonight. Nunez at 231 hitting. Two home runs. Again?
Okay, I'll do it. Pizza, pizza.
Simmons ready. Infield back for the Revs here early. First pitch is swung on and missed. He reached for the first one. Not one he would have wanted on the first pitch. No balls and a strike. Nunez, a former American Association infielder with Lincoln a couple years ago. He hit 320 2 years ago the last time he played. Now time asked for at the plate.
If you'll recall, at the beginning of the season, it was like he was shot out of a pistol. He was hitting close to 500 for the first week and a half and has since fallen back into more in line with his typical numbers.
Fastball away, 1-1. And Simmons says there's no way that that was away. He's shaking his head, looking in at home plate, and didn't care for it. Now, they went in a similar spot that Nunez swung and missed on the first pitch. And this one foul tipped off of Erie and deflects just right of the screen, and the gentleman in the front row caught it. A 1-2 and chance at some breadsticks here. No score, second inning. Lights are coming on early. Fair skies tonight. Simmons the pitch, and a curveball loop to left toward the line. It's going to drop. One run in. They're sending Galvez. Rockets throw home strong, but it skips away, and Simmons slipped and tumbled trying to back it up and slipped a second time trying to get to his feet. There's all kinds of divots taken out of the grass behind home plate. Nunez ends up at third on the throw home. Simmons looked back to see what kind of damage he had done as his feet went out from under him, and it's a two-run hit for Nunez. He tried to get him on the big curve but left it up and over the plate, and Nunez loops it into left for the damaging first two runs, and Chong is going to come out and make sure Simmons is all right after that spill. Mace on his way to the mound here as well. Simmons kind of shrugging his shoulders upward and looking skyward to stretch out the neck and shoulder area. Took a nasty, unexpected spill when he slipped behind home plate.
I can imagine Nunez's eyes got about as big as downtown's eyes. Hanging curveball left right up there. Nunez had to tell himself to be patient and not overswing at that ball. Squared up, solid contact, bringing both of the batters home. And that's a pitch that most players in this league are going to be able to swat.
And Rocket, a pretty strong throw home, but on target left-right wise, but it took an in-between hop on Erie, who couldn't save it, trying to make the tag at the same time. And a rare error charged to Rocket as Nunez made it all the way to third. So Simmons discussing his physical status with Chong and Mace, and he's going to take a couple of warm-ups. The thing there, the way he landed on his left side, very awkward on his glove arm. It was kind of trapped and extended underneath of him, and he tried to brace himself, and it looked like all the weight went on his left shoulder and arm. Kind of got trapped and tangled under his body weight, and he says he's fine, fortunately, and will be able to stay in. At Bridgeport, the first two runs of the night. Now we go to the top of the order, and Luis Hernandez. Simmons retired on a ground out to start the game. The Bluefish, another runner at third and only one out. The small ball here this inning has been very productive for them. With the infield back, a ground ball could make it 3-0 here early on. Simmons from the windup. And the pitch to Hernandez fouled off. No balls and a strike. Some darker skies toward the north and east. There were some storms to the north earlier today. Hopefully we don't have any issue here tonight. On a scorcher, 0-1. And it missed inside, a ball. The Revs behind early, which has not been a bad thing. Pitch from Simmons is inside, 2-1. We've had good comeback teams here before, but we've never had a team where you think when they get behind, oh, good.
Where it seems to activate them, like the game hasn't even begun until they've given up a run or two.
Yeah.
Or eight in some cases.
2-1, he swings and lines a foul way off to the left. Two balls, two strikes. And even with two strikes, the Revs will keep that infield back. They're not worried about making up three early runs. The 2-2, and a swing and a foul again back over the roof. Simmons on that road trip, 13 innings, 3 runs, just 8 hits across his 2 starts. And winning at New Britain and then at Southern Maryland. On the wind and the 2-2 again, and a liner down the line and right and fair. And into score is Nunez. Hernandez heading for second as it rattles out of the corner. He's got an RBI double, and it's 3-0. And they tried to run one down and in and cut it, but Hernandez stayed short, stayed inside of it, and turned on it. Now a 3-0 game. We'll pause for station identification. This is Revolution Radio.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
Now the Revs behind by 3 here early tonight. Here's Andy Chavez. Simmons fires and missed inside. Chavez a blue pit to left back in the first.
Dale, you remember 3 months ago, Corey Thurman's retirement jersey ceremony and the storm that followed? Well, they've got it now at Yankee Stadium.
Oh, no. Here's a called strike at the knees, 1-1.
Live shot, Jared Diamond, who covers the Yankees at the Daily News.
Oh, my.
He tweets, another look at the coming apocalypse. Tarp on the field, black skies beyond left center field. And the video board, of course, says, thank you, A-Rod.
On the 1-1 fastball, that's low. That is serious right there. That sky that's on that picture. Well, we have our WOYK bus trip.
Yes.
There tonight.
Fortunately, they have a luxury suite.
More time for the complimentary all-inclusive food and beverage, no doubt. Here's a swing and a miss on a fastball, 2-2.
If I wasn't here, I'd want to be there.
Yeah, you and me both. Wonder if that's the band that went through Central PA earlier today. Some severe storms to the north earlier. Simmons holds in the 2-2. Swing and a grounder, slap to short. Wilson's got it. He'll throw to first for the out, and Hernandez started toward third and was right in front of that ground ball and then decided to duck back to second base. He would have been in real trouble had he kept running. So he stays at second with two outs. There's a Cuevas to the plate. Cuevas singled his first time up. Simmons the pitch. And a little flare at second on one hop. Chavez is there backing up to play the hop. He'll throw over to first, and that'll end the inning. Up Bridgeport with the game's first three on four hits, one error, one runner left. We go to the bottom of the second inning. Revs behind early. It's 3-0.
Cheerleading takes on many different forms across many different age groups. In other words,
this is not your mother's cheerleading squad.
Flying feet.
Today, cheering means youth pep squad, high school and college sideline squad, competition stunting squads, gymnastic tumbling squads, and every type of squad calls for different types of equipment. But no matter what they're cheering for, Flying Feet Sports Shoes has it. Flying Feet has been outfitting cheerleading programs throughout Central PA and Northern Maryland since 1982. They specialize in cheerleading shoes from Asics, Infinity, Kappa, and more, including a large inventory of cheer briefs and boycott shorts, bodysuits, and crop tops in all the right colors. Socks, warm-ups, carry bags, rain jackets, megaphones, pom-poms, Flying Feet has them all with prices that meet or beat internet suppliers. And because they're in stock, you can try them on.
Try doing that with your mouse.
Individuals, small squads, entire teams, no matter what you're cheering for,
Flying Feet.
1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, a half mile west of exit 18 off I-83.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles, whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both. It is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
For local sports on your smartphone, search WOIK at the App Store.
The Revs an early three to make up tonight. 3-0 as they come to bat trailing here in the second. Brandon Chavez a leadoff. The inflatables between innings. And now we're ready to go as Kubiak stands tall on the mound. His first pitch of the inning is down and in, and that deflects away.
That was, I think, one of the better Shipley energy balls that we've seen this season. Twice, both of the contestants got knocked down, and the other one just slammed the other one to the turf.
The fastball over for a strike. Good night and big balls.
Boy, is Wipeout back?
Yeah. Kubiak, a product of SUNY Albany. And delivers, and a swing and a miss, a slider that sends Chavez to a knee. 1-2. And a wind and the pitch. Ooh, look out, in by his feet. He dances out of the way. He had been in the Rays system for a year And then from there went to the Frontier League and was tremendous as a reliever mostly. Evansville, Southern Illinois, and Joliet. He deals, and just outside, and Chavez will run it full. This is his first Atlantic League season. He had been in the Frontier League each of his previous 3 years. Pitch to Chavez is lofted to center. Coming in is Endy Chavez and makes the grab. No relation. Brandon with
different spellings for
yeah.
One.
One down, and Brian Pounds to the plate.
Who'll be a product of the State University of New York in Albany, one of the proud SUNY schools, America East Conference. Spent 4 years there, did a fine job.
First pitch to Pounds, it cuts outside for ball one.
Andres Perez, a graduate of the SUNY system, he went to SUNY Stony Brook. Of course, shortened to just Stony Brook nowadays.
The 1-0, and that's down low. There's a lot of Division III SUNY schools that make up their own conference, the SUNYAC. As Kubiak takes a stroll behind the mound.
Like there's a lot of Wisconsin schools that do that too, Division III.
2-0, and that's in tight, ball three. Yeah, they have their own conference in Wisconsin. They're always competing on the national stage at that level. And a cutter runs away. Pounds had to look back to be sure. He's got ball four. That outside part of the play, not very wide tonight. So he made it certain that it was ball four, and the Revs have their second walk off Kubiak. Here's Brian Erie playing in his second game with the Revs tonight. 0 for 3 two nights ago in his debut, but he caught a shutout on Wednesday against New Britain. Micah Owings and three relievers. First pitch here, swing and a miss, a cutter. Bluefish a 3-0 lead. They're a game and a half behind Long Island in the Liberty Division race. Pitch to Erie, a swing and a miss. Kubiak back-to-back cutters, and he's got a good one. Bluefish with the three-game losing streak, now 17-16 in the second half. It's after they went 30-40 in the first half. 0-2. And a curveball, bent back, and a called third strike. Started at Erie and hooked down, and he's got words for DeBrower on his way to the dugout. Always trust what the catchers say because they're the ones back there catching all night, and they know the boundaries of the strike zone better than any. Kubiak with his fourth strikeout out of five total outs. Here's Josh Wilson with Pounds at first and two away. Kubiak fires and a curveball down and in.
Bridgeport and a whole host of other teams across the Atlantic League. They're either rooting for themselves, but if they can't win it, they're rooting for both York and Long Island because then they'll have a chance to get a wild card potentially.
It's a fastball for a strike. It is 1-1.
Well, the Bridgeport's avenue is pretty clear. After finishing last in the Liberty Division in the first half, they're almost certainly going to have to win the second half of the division to make the playoffs.
Pitch, curveball in tight. Wilson a late backup. He hung in there, was maybe thinking about taking one for the team.
Meanwhile, you're looking at Somerset, who finished two games back of Long Island in the first half in that division. Somerset, of course, chasing it, but they're in third place right now. They're going to want Long Island to keep winning so Somerset can get a wild card.
There's a swing and a miss, a changeup down low, 2-2.
A strange dichotomy. It's one of those, if I can't have him, then the other guy can.
Revs are half game behind Sugar Land after the Skeeters swept in Bridgeport. Sugar Land. 21-13 in the second half. York 20-13. Pitch to Wilson, a swing and a miss. A lot of hooks from Kubiak in the second inning. And he throws one to finish the job. Five strikeouts through two innings. No runs, no hits, one left. We go to the third, 3-0 Bridgeport.
The more we help the ones in need, the more progress our community will make.
By focusing on quality education, income opportunities, and basic health care,
all of York County can have access to the building blocks of a good quality of life.
Together, we can load the bases for our community.
And hit a home run.
Give generously to the 2016 United Way Community Fund.
Find out more and give now at unitedway-york.org.
Money and business are essential to the strength of a community. So is cheering and celebration and music and fun. That's why York Revolution games, concerts, youth sports, special events, and more happen at a place called People's Bank Park. People's Bank has been serving York County for more than 150 years. Always cheering, always celebrating, always committed to the things that make York County great. And to you having a great time at People's Bank Park. People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Ross Brothers Barbecue is serving up the hits every Saturday night this season at People's Bank Park. Stop by Arch Street Eats on the third base corner and load up on delicious, fresh-made local barbecue. All of Ross's sauces and sides are made from scratch daily. All meats are smoked for an authentic barbecue done right. Ross Brothers also offers drive-through, dine-in, and carry-out from the restaurant at 3096 Carlisle Road in Dover, as well as delivery and full-service catering. Ross Brothers can cater any sized event from fundraisers to graduation parties to weddings. Ross Brothers Barbecue every Saturday night at People's Bank Park.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the third, 3-0 Bridgeport. Sean Burrows to lead off. Be interesting to see how Simmons approaches him here. He struck him out on three fastballs in a row in the first inning. And his first pitch here this time is a fastball, and he fouls it off third base side, but late on it. Now, if you can, stick with it until the guy proves that he can hit it. Now the 0-1, and a fastball missed upstairs. All five pitches that Burrows has seen have been heaters. There's the wind from Simmons, the 1-1, and a fastball just outside. Two previous starts for him against Bridgeport, one at their place. It was the game that York came back with seven in the ninth to win 9-7. Here's a foul back to the screen, 2-2. It's back on May 31st, and he struggled early, but hung in to go seven innings. You know, he gave up seven runs. And June 17th, he faced them at home, 6 1/3, four runs on four solo homers. Here's a curveball, swing and a miss. 65, lighting up the gun.
And lighting up Burrows' face. He had a big smile, a sort of a grimace after that pitch.
Simmons with two strikeouts, both of Burrows, and one away here to start the third inning. Bring up Wellington Dotel, who popped up to second base his first time up. He will call time and back out for a moment. Some gnats near home plate, apparently. Now Simmons the wind in the pitch, and Dotel shortens but takes outside for ball one. It'll be an important stretch for the Bluefish coming up. Tonight begins a stretch where they play 13 out of 16 on the road. Here's a swing and a bouncer to third. Two easy hops to Pounds, and he rifles it to first, two away. Simmons looking to settle in after that rocky second inning. And the guy who started it, Jose Heel, coming up, he singled to right leading off. And he's now 5-for-7 against York this season. 3-0, the Bluefish on top. And Simmons with the pitch, breaking ball, and it's over for a strike. That one a much more conventional 73 miles an hour. Now the 0-1. Fastball called strike, follows it up with the fastball in the outer half. Ahead of heel, nothing and two, pitching him backwards here. Two strike pitch, he dropped down and just missed the corner away, which has really not been there tonight, 1-2.
As long as it's not there for both sides.
Pitch. And a breaking ball down and away, and Erie scrambling to get in front of it just in case Heel were to swing. That one at 66 miles an hour. 2-2. Simmons the kick and the pitch, and a slider darts outside, 3-2. He's ahead of him quickly. Now a full count. And we'll go back in. The payoff pitch, a rip toward the middle and a base hit. Now he was going for his first 1-2-3 inning of the night. But after working it full, he'll slaps the base hit to the right of second and into the outfield. A two-out single. He's 2-for-2 tonight. And now Jonathan Galvez, the hitter, and last inning he caught everybody by surprise bunting, and he ended up with a bunt hit. And that was, aside from the run scoring hits, maybe the biggest one of the inning. It really set things up as he fouls the first pitch back off the net, 0-1. Well, that made it first and second, and another sack bunt made it second and third, and they were set up for multiple runs. Stretch from Simmons. And the 0-1. And a swing and a liner yanked foul to the top of the end section and left. Right off one of the signs in front of Arch Street Eats. It's 0-2. That time they wanted to go in, and it was so far in that that's all Galvez could do with it. That's the thing. If you want to go in, pitchers need to make sure they get it in. Runner goes. A curveball here is swung on and missed. 65 on that one. And Galvez fans on it. Scoreless third for James Simmons. His third strikeout. No runs, one hit, and one left. We go to the bottom of the third. Still 3-0 Bridgeport.
Take it from me, guys. You want to make life happier? Your wife wants a nicer lawn, the kind of lawn you see on Home and Gardens and Martha Stewart. Here's a hint, you're not alone. Call your pals at Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. They've got a way with lush lawns that the ladies like. And as you know, happy wifey, happy hubby, winky face. Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, world-class care right in your backyard. 717-292-9994.
Need a quick oil change? Get spoiled at the Lube Center, home of the drive-thru oil change, and now the oil cam, where you can watch us work from the driver's seat of your car. The Lube Center specializes in fast oil changes, preventative maintenance, and PA state inspections. Their personable staff will make you feel right at home 7 days a week. With two convenient locations, York and the Two Guys Shopping Center, and Shrewsbury across from Home Depot. More than ever, it's easy to get spoiled at the Lube Center. Visit thelubecenter.com for more information. The Lube Center. Get spoiled.
Ugh, Wednesdays are the worst. I've got to get the kids to school on time to get to work, then it's just one long day of meetings. But hey, at least I don't have to worry about making dinner.
Kids eat free with People's Bank. Save money at every Wednesday home game.
So now when the Revs are in town, I just pull into a People's Bank, pick up that week's coupon, and dinner is done. Revolution Wednesdays? Awesome. Revolution!
Thanks to People's Bank, kids eat free at every Wednesday home game. No need to be a People's Bank customer. Just pick up your coupon at any People's Bank branch and do dinner at People's Bank Park. One coupon per child per game.
York Sports on your mobile device or online at WOYK1350.com.
Revs down 3-0. Top of the order, and Travis Witherspoon to lead off here in the bottom of the third. Bluefish with 7 hits early on to York's 1. Got plenty of time to turn that around. Witherspoon a strikeout against Kubiak, his first time up. And the 6-7 righty. A long look in and finally has his first sign. First pitch of the inning, runs away. He's got a lot of late tail, and it could be a longer night for him if he's not getting the outside. Neither pitcher seems to be early. A 1-0 and a bouncer to short. Over to his right, Hernandez to get in front. A long throw, but it is there and gets Witherspoon by a step and a half. Now the first ground out for Kubiak. 5 of his 6 outs, the first 2 innings on K's. And here's Jared Mitchell, who he also struck out in the first inning. Last visit for the Bluefish this year. Pitch to Mitchell, he shows a bunt, and Kubiak missing low, it got through heel. They came in here and took 2 out of 3 with a couple of weeks to go in the first half. One of the rare hiccups for the Revs in pursuit of that first half title. The 1-0, and Mitchell shows bunt. It's over for a strike. Revs will be at Bridgeport a couple of weeks from now for 4. And that'll do it for the two teams, unless a playoff meeting arises. Here's a curveball low, 2-1. The wind and the pitch, and that's taken low. If that were to happen, the Revs and Bluefish have met in the postseason once. Of course, that was the 2010 championship series that York swept. 3-1, and a swing and a bouncing ball, second base. 2 hops to Nunez, he'll toss it on to first. Back-to-back ground outs for Kubiak to begin the third. Yeah, he's been in control here early with his team leading 3-0. Joel Guzman coming up with 2 outs.
Guz has the only hit off of him today, a single that he grounded up the middle in the first inning.
First pitch this time, swing and a miss. And that had some funky movement to it. That almost had splitter break. A little more downward than the curves we've seen. 0-1, and there's a curve and missed in.
Heck, you can always gauge the nastiness of a pitch by how silly the swing is.
1-1, and oh, a liner off Kubiak's midsection. He picks it up and underhands to first to end the inning. But he can't even hide this one. That hurt. And he's wincing and grimacing as he slowly walks toward their dugout. Burrows from first and his catcher Hill walking side by side with him, quickly over to him to make sure he's okay. A wicked shot. But it's a 1-2-3 inning. And we'll head to the fourth. Will DeBoer with the call. Revs trail the Bluefish 3-0.
Smith, Mayer, and Little is a holistic wealth management group with one product, advice. We aim to simplify our clients' lives, help them retire comfortably, and build lasting legacies for their families and the causes they care about. Our purpose is simple, to make a meaningful difference in the lives of our clients, our community, and the world in which we live with the advice we provide. Smith, Mayer, and Little, a wealth of knowledge about wealth. We make our living by making a difference. Visit us at financialjava.com.
Janie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Let's welcome back the second most famous groundhog in Pennsylvania. So, Gus, if you were a superhero, what would your name be and what power would you have?
Well, I'm a groundhog, so I'd like to fly.
and I'd be Wonder Gus.
Much like Wonder Bucks, the new instant game from the Pennsylvania Lottery with top prizes of 300 grand.
Now that's a super prize.
Until next time, folks.
Keep on scratching.
The Pennsylvania Lottery. Players must be 18 or older. Please play responsibly. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day.
Eric Hosmer's got nothing on this. Mad Dash Grilled Cheese is comfort food at its finest. Mad Dash is Central PA's favorite artisan grilled cheese truck, bringing you creative concoctions with the freshest and most flavorful ingredients. Available for food truck festivals, weddings, corporate, and private caterings. Find Mad Dash this year along the third baseline at People's Bank Park for all York Revolution home games. Call 717-574-5168 or visit online at mad-grilledcheese.com. Mad Dash Artisan Grilled Cheese. Welcome home.
First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the fourth from People's Bank Park. Bluefish 3, Revs nothing. Inya, Nunez, and Hernandez up in the first pitch to Angelus. Nina is taken on the outside corner, called strike one. Well, the cast ball wasn't the only thing that was rocked in the last half inning. David Kubiak took one off the midsection as Nina takes a breaking ball, outer half again, strike two. On replay, it looked like it hit the bottom of his stomach, so about a foot higher than the really danger zone as Simmons comes back with a fastball and misses well away for ball one. Well, that's one way to deny Joel Guzman of a base hit. Just get your body in front of it. And still just one hit against for Kubiak. 1-2 pitch, sharp grounder over to short, taken up by Wilson. He's got it, throw over to first in time, one away. That changed up on Wilson at the last moment as it deflected off the mound as it was headed his way. Didn't take any of the speed off of it, but caused it to hook just a bit to his right. But Wilson able to make the adjustment and make the play cleanly. Here's Luis Nunez, two-run single back in the second inning on that hanging curveball. He later scored on a double by Luis Hernandez. Simmons into the windup. Here comes the pitch. Breaking ball. Nunez sits on this one, flies it deep to left field, but Rocket locates, trots to his left, makes the catch, two away. Our out-of-town scoreboard is brought to you by York Mitsubishi. On a full night in the Atlantic League, every game underway. Bottom five from New Britain, Bees and Sugarland tied at one apiece. Top four from Long Island, Ducks down 4-0 as Lancaster scored four runs in the top of the first. And they are just underway in Somerset, Patriots hosting the Blue Crabs as that game was delayed until a 7:25 start time because of the rain that's delaying the game at Yankee Stadium right now. First pitch fastball rides inside, ball one against Luis Hernandez. Hernandez, a RBI double back in the second inning. 1-0 pitch, this one golfed down the left field line. Rocket a long run as he was shifted to his right, and he takes it off to the base of the arch nemesis. And a quick throw back in as Luis Hernandez is held to a single. Well, he struck that ball a touch too well, otherwise he might have had extra bases. But Hernandez, 2-for-3 as the Bluefish are already sending their men up for the third time against James Simmons tonight. 67 pitches for him through 3 2/3 innings. And he's still without a 1-2-3 frame. He battles with Hernandez on first, two outs, and Andy Chavez up next. Chavez had that Bermuda Triangle bloop single down the left field line in the first, and he later grounded out to short. Simmons ready at the chest. The kick in the first pitch. Chavez loops it foul and out of play over the third base luxury suites, and the count nothing and one. Bluefish 3, Revs nothing. Top of the fourth inning on a blistering night at People's Bank Park. Blistering, not quite blustery, although the wind is blowing out to center field a touch. Simmons snap throw back over to first base to hold Hernandez aboard. Luis with 5 stolen bases this year. He's been caught 5 times as well. Never a blazing speed guy, but he'll get you about 7, 8, 9 stolen bases a year. 0-1 pitch, Chavez sends one sharply to short. Wilson tried to pick the short hop, and it got under his mitt into left for a base hit. Or no, they're going to call this one an error against Josh Wilson. And I think judging based on Wilson's pedigree, yeah, that probably would be an error. Rare miscue from Josh at short, and that puts two on with two out. Table set for the man who likes the table set, Jose Cuevas. Third hitter in the Bluefish order. He is 1-for-2 in his first two trips. Simmons will look back to second base. Here's the kick and the first pitch. It's breaking ball low and away. Erie diving to his right to get in front of that one. And it's ball one. Cuevas from the Bronx. He would have been about 16 when Alex Rodriguez first came to the New York Yankees. 1-0 pitch swung on and missed for strike one, snapping an 87-mile-an-hour fastball at him, and the count 1-1. Of course, most famously in that offseason between 2003 and 2004 when the Boston Red Sox had a deal in place and they even had A-Rod agreeing to a pay cut in order to go to Boston. That trade was eventually nixed by the Players Union in Major League Baseball. 1-1 pitch swung on and missed for strike two, a fastball riding away. And now it's 1-2 to Jose Cuevas. And a couple of months later, the Yankees, on the spur of the moment, after having gone to the World Series but lost, decided, well, heck, we'll take him. So they took him, and thus, well, the rest, as they say, is history. 1-2 pitch, fastball is in there. Strike three called. Got him to the fastball, outer black. Simmons dropping down an arm slot for that pitch, and he's able to freeze Cuevas. For the Bluefish, no runs on one hit, one error, two men left on base. Middle of the fourth, your score. Bridgeport 3, York nothing on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
Come and celebrate 10 years of York Revolution Baseball with the Celebrate York Series presented by Memorial Hospital. The series honors significant contributions from York, Pennsylvania's most notable events and favorite citizens with giveaways every Friday night home game. The series continues on Friday, September 2nd with a bobblehead giveaway of York's favorite mascot, Downtown. Visit YorkRevolution.com for more details. It's the Celebrate York Series, proudly presented by Memorial Hospital for the York Revolution's 10th anniversary season.
Pain doesn't take Sunday off, neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
Getting pumped for another year of high school football? All this month, Sports Radio 1350 WOIK lays it all out for you in the High School Football Spotlight, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine. Catch a preview every day in August on Sports Radio 1350 as we break down the teams and the players of the 2016 York Adams League. Or go to WOIK1350.com to access this year's complete lineup of high school football preview. Then, this fall, every Friday night, it's the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine. Only here on Sports Radio 1350.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
We head to the last of the fourth. Revs down 3-0, sending the middle of the order. It's Rivers, Rocket, and Chavez up to face David Kubiak, who is all rested, unsore, and his first pitch is a fastball that dips into the dirt for ball one to Kevin Rivers, who walked his first time up. Scoring change from the last half inning. They are not going to charge an error to Josh Wilson. Instead, it'll be a single for Andy Chavez. Make it no runs on two hits and no errors and two left on base for Bridgeport in the inning. Rivers taking low, ball two. In any case, Simmons working out of trouble once again. He gave up two out singles to Hernandez and Chavez and able to strike out a tough hitter in Cuevas. Rivers takes a strike letter high on the outside corner, and it's 2-1. Rivers back in the lineup after his own injury scare a couple of days ago as he chases after a slider that dips well below the knees. It's 2-2. That collision with Jake McWiggin, the New Britain shortstop, over at first base in the top of the ninth on Tuesday, sidelining him. There's a fastball, low and away, ball three. Just general soreness for Kevin Rivers, keeping him out, but he is back, rested, healthy, and ready to face a payoff pitch. It is low, ball four. Leadoff walk issued to Kevin Rivers, who has yet to record an official at bat since returning from the injury. And the leadoff man's aboard for Michael Rocket. On the Wellspan Sports Medicine injury report, Michael Burgess in the DL with the meniscus surgery. He is a couple of weeks away, we hope, from getting back. And Mariel Checo with the elbow issue hasn't pitched in almost 2 months now. Michael Rocket takes a breaking ball that veers in inner black at the last possible moment for strike one. For Bridgeport, they've got Mike Antonini, the pitcher, on the DL. And there's a breaking ball that misses in on Rocket. One ball and one strike. They're also working sans Luis Rodriguez, the infielder. Everybody else healthy and raring to go. 1-1 pitch, another breaking ball. That's in the zone, and Rocket has a word with Brian DeBrower. He was not pleased with that call. He hasn't been pleased with the strike zone for most of the night. This team is as familiar with this umpire, they might as well be kin at this point. And still the familiarity doesn't give them a clue as to the zone. 1-2 pitch. This one slapped into right center. That's a base hit. Dotel trying to cut off. He does before it gets to the wall. But everybody rounding and taking the extra base. Rivers to third. Michael Rocket into second with a double. And the Revs have men in scoring position with nobody out in the last of the four. Rocket gives it enough of a ride to get it into right center field, but it slows down enough that Wellington Dotel has to run a long way to it, and with Rocket speed, forget about it. So Brandon Chavez up next. Time is asked for, and we'll see Jesse Litch, the Bridgeport pitching coach, for the first time this evening. David Kubiak, after three scoreless, is in some kind of a pickle in the bottom of the fourth. Rivers on third, Rocket on second with nobody out. Sun starting to set over the Codorus Creek out behind the arch nemesis in left field. Oh, just hints of yellow and a light blue sky overhead. Beautiful night for baseball, and the Revs are trying to make it a more beautiful scoreboard. Down 3-0 for the moment. And an early clutch situation for Brandon Chavez, who will work with a matinee sort of spotlight on him, just like the Stage Deli has a spotlight on outstanding soup, salads, and sandwiches. For daily specials, including catering options, visit Facebook and search for Stage Deli on George or in person, North George Street, Strand Capital Theater. Chavez takes a breaking ball at the knees for strike one. Chavi, a fly out to center his first time up, struck it well, but right at Andy Chavez. Now Chavez is asking for the LED boards to be changed for the moment. Rare to see that out of a home hitter. Kubiak with the 0-1 pitch. Slow breaking ball, and he misses away. Ball one. Well, Chavez, quite a clutch performer. 385 with men in scoring position. He's driven in 11 runs in this situation. And a fastball dips low from Kubiak. It's two balls and one strike. Revs trying to start the comeback trail early in this one. They gave up 3 runs in the top of the second inning. Have a chance to get it back and more in the fourth. 2-1 swung on and missed for strike two. A breaking ball that bounced well into the dirt and off to the right where Heel had to go and chase after it. Kubiak charging hard to the plate to cover, but that one too close for anyone to think about advancing. The big sort of breaking ball and swing that you normally only see on strike three. Instead, Xavi will step in. He'll have a 2-2 pitch coming up. Well, a switch hitter digs in. Open stance for him. Bat on the shoulder and off. 2-2 pitch swung on and missed for strike three. There's a curveball that Chavez comes up empty on. Another strikeout for David Kubiak, who's been racking up the Ks all evening. Six strikeouts for him. Also means he's been racking up the pitch count now. 68 pitches to get through three and a third innings. Looks like it's going to be an early night for both bullpens tonight. Brian Pounds walked on four pitches back in the second inning. Now Pounds comes in with Rivers on third, Rock on second, one out. Kubiak from the stretch comes in and plunks him. That's on the left forearm, close to the elbow. And Pounds still hasn't seen a pitch in the strike zone tonight. He trots over to first, and that loads him up. And the new guy is going to have his biggest chance at the plate thus far, Brian Erie. Erie, who struck out looking back in the second, will have a big chance. Revs down 3-0. A gapper could tie it. Of course, his chance to test out that big wall in left, too. Swings the first pitch and misses, a slider that veers low, and it's no balls and one strike. Prime opportunity for the Revs, but they'll need the bottom of the order to get it done. Kubiak, a look back at Rocket on second. Now the 0-1 pitch, fastball, that's low and away, ball one. There he steps back in. Black cleats with red heel. Looks like the black fades into the red. 1-1 pitch, nasty breaking ball, that catches inner black for called strike two. Well, the Brower's been given the inner part of the plate, but not the outer. Like a car that's been misaligned to steer left. The 1-2 from Kubiak swung on and missed for strike three. Got him with a slider. Back-to-back strikeouts. Well, a hit batsman sandwiched in between, but two strikeouts in the inning for Kubiak. So, instead of second and third with nobody out, it's bases loaded, two outs. Revs still not on the board yet, and Josh Wilson the last chance potentially in this inning. Wilson, a swinging strikeout back in the second. And the first pitch from Kubiak, a little half swing and he went around, strike one. Wilson sitting fastball, he recognized breaking ball just a hair too late, and he can't hold the wrists. 3-0 Bluefish for the moment. Kubiak, the kick in the 0-1 pitch. And Wilson drives this one out to center field, but playable. Andy Chavez trotting back, locates, makes a two-handed catch, side retired. So a prime opportunity for the Revs, a rare situation for them in which they do not capitalize. For York, no runs on one hit, no errors, three men left on base. End of the fourth, your score, Bridgeport 3, York nothing, on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
You hear a lot about CPAP masks these days, but here's something you don't hear much about. Over half of the people who wear a CPAP mask for sleep stop wearing it within a year. How's that working for you? Dr. Gordon Bell would like you to hear this. York Dental Sleep Therapy has dental options that can help many of those people. If you or someone you live with is struggling with sleep apnea, visit YorkSleep.com and see how Dr. Gordon Bell can help return your home to peaceful nights of deep, restful sleep. If you're groggy during the workday, if you wake up feeling exhausted, if you would like to get your nighttime sleep patterns back to a healthy state, get a confirmation from your doctor, then meet with Dr. Bell at his office on West Market Street in Hallam. He'll evaluate your symptoms and discuss which treatments would best suit your situation. Dr. Bell can restore restful sleep, and gets you feeling better day and night. York Dental Sleep Therapy. Call 316-1299 or visit yorksleep.com to learn more.
You trust AAA to work at every mile. But AAA doesn't just cover your car. They can also cover your home. AAA Home Insurance protects every square foot. And when you add AAA Home Insurance to AAA Auto Insurance, you get more protection and more savings. Insurance that's not just insurance. Talk to your local AAA insurance agent today or visit AAA.com to learn more about AAA Home Insurance.
Follow York Sports on your Android. Search Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the fifth from People's Bank Park. Bluefish 3, Revs nothing. James Simmons back on for his fifth inning of work. He will face 4, 5, and 6 hitters for Bridgeport. First, Sean Burrows. Strikeout victim twice, mostly on fastballs, and he takes a fastball at the knees for called strike one. Burrows, of course, famous as a Little League World Series alumnus in the early 90s. He takes away on a curveball, 1-1. Back-to-back championships with that team from Long Beach as he drills one deep to right field. Going back on it, Mitchell to the track, back at the wall, turn and watch it go. Sean Burrows with a solo home run just to the left of Cannonball Charlie's set up in right center. His first home run of the whole season. And that makes it 4-0 for Bridgeport here in the top of the fifth. Well, there's one fastball that Burrows finally got around on, and oh boy, did he. Now here's Wellington Dotel, who's 0-2 today. He takes a fastball right down George Street for called strike one. And the home runs have haunted Simmons this season as Dotel grounds one foul down the third baseline. Count goes nothing and two. That's the 15th he's given up this season. That puts him alone in third place in the Atlantic League. Simmons with the 0-2 pitch, breaking ball low and away, 68 mile an hour. Dotel able to watch it go. And that's one ball and two strikes. Now the 1-2, low and away, about the same spot on a curveball. It is 2-2 to Wellington Dotel. That big, about as open a stance as you've seen from anybody. And he swings and misses at a breaking ball at 64. Belated call fall to his knee as Dotel wanted all of that one and he got nothing. Fourth strikeout for Simmons. That's the first out of this top of the fifth inning. As Daryl Henry apparently followed my lead from the pregame and got himself a mountain of ice cream. Is that the Rocky Road? Moose tracks. Well, don't be tracking moose through here, all right? It's small enough already. Jose Heal takes a ball right down the middle. Fastball. Apparently, quantum physics in play with the strike zone tonight. Simmons coming back into the wind with the 1-0 pitch. This one drilled out to center field, but playable. Witherspoon trotting in to his left. And he comes in to make the catch, two away. 4-0 Bridgeport. Four runs on 10 hits already for the Bluefish with no errors. York, no runs on two hits and one error as the offense still needs a bit of a restart. Only scored three in their last two games and scoreless to the first four. Jonathan Galvez takes a fastball that misses away for ball one. Galvez with that surprise bunt single in the second, the middle of the three-run inning. And he struck out his next time up. And that fastball tried to thread the needle on the outside and ends up missing for ball two. Galvez has a big slugger's body. 2-0 pitch is drilled but foul down the third baseline, scooped up by a Bridgeport relief pitcher. Usually it sends all them scattered on the bench there, but that time everybody keeping their calm. Two balls and a strike now from Simmons. Here's the rock and the roll. And a bouncer towards the right side. Long run for Chavez to his knees on the grass. The spinorama, and he got him at first base. Brandon Chavez showing a shortstop's reins at second base. 4-3, a nifty put out for him. And that will retire the side, but Bridgeport with another run on Sean Burroughs' leadoff homer. One run on one hit and no errors. Nobody left on base. Middle of the fifth, your score, Bridgeport 4, York nothing on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
Brimmer has been York's licensed and notary specialist since 1969. An approved online messenger for PennDOT, it offers registration and driver's license renewals, online title transfers, money orders, and notary service, all with a friendly staff that guarantees your satisfaction. For more information on Brimmer's convenient hours and fast service, call 717-699-1060 in York or visit them on the web at brimmers.com. Brimmer Fast Licensing and Notary Service with 4 convenient locations in York and Lancaster.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at your SureSave neighborhood markets. Use your gold card every time you shop, and you automatically receive savings and rewards. And get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Sauble's Markets, Wetzel's Market, and also at Nell's Market Fresh Foods. Always a hit and always great savings.
Have you got game? Do you love playing baseball? If you're between the ages of 8 and 16 and want to take your skills to the next level with more competitive play, try out for the York Young Revolution. The York Young Revolution is an elite tournament baseball organization that offers you the opportunity to play a higher caliber baseball as well as to play with other players who love the game just as much as you do. York Young Revolution will be hosting tryouts in August. Visit YorkYoungRevolution.com and click on the registration button to take your skills to the next level. York Young Revolution is a 501c3 not-for-profit organization.
There's only one place for local high school sports. Sports Radio 1350.
Four nothing Bluefish as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Top of the order due up for the third time for the Revs. It's Witherspoon, Mitchell, and Guzman. David Kubiak working on a two-hit shutout, but he may not be long for this game as he's up at 75 pitches through his first four innings. Travis Witherspoon 0 for 2 today. Most of the Revs are. Kubiak's first pitch, bunt shown. Witherspoon stabbed at it and missed for strike one. Spoonie a strikeout and a ground ball to short his first two trips to the plate. And he digs back in, taps the near side of the plate to him, the right-handed hitter, and he'll face an 0-1 pitch. That's a breaking ball. It crosses letter high for called strike two. Kubiak has been mixing the speed and the breaking stuff quite effectively tonight as the 0-2 fastball comes low and in, juggled by Heel as he tosses it up from his right side and catches it in the mitt again. Oh, maybe Mad Chad was over in Bridgeport recently, too, like he was a couple of weeks ago here at People's Bank Park. 1-2 from Kubiak, and it's fouled back to the screen. Witherspoon fighting to stay alive, and he does. One ball and two strikes. Witherspoon, no stranger to this sort of heat. He's from Sumter, South Carolina. Went to college at Spartanburg Methodist. Sweat for a couple of years, then turn pro as he takes a fastball in at the knees for ball two. Then he goes about as far away as you possibly can from Sumter, South Carolina. He began his pro career in Orem, Utah with the Orem Owls. There's a swing and a miss at a fastball for strike three. Spoonie chasing one outside. Another strikeout for Kubiak. twice he's gotten Witherspoon that way. That is eight strikeouts for David Kubiak through four and a third innings. Now here's Jared Mitchell, who's 0 for 2. Same way as Witherspoon, a strikeout and a ground out. Kubiak wheels and deals. Big breaking ball, outer black, called strike one. Kubiak's been nibbling and munching. Nibbled that time. 0-1, fastball coming in on Mitchell, and it's one ball and one strike. 4-0 Bluefish. Bottom of the fifth inning. The kick and the 1-1 pitch, and Mitchell sends one out to left field. Nina coasting along the warning track in front of the arch nemesis. He makes the catch, two away. And with that, let's pause 10 seconds for station ID on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
Well, DeBoer, Daryl Henry, some moose tracks and the Goos. Just a typical Friday night in South Central PA. Joel Guzman is 1 for 2 today. And the first pitch from Kubiak is roped down the left field line. If it stays fair, it does. It's into the corner, takes a high hop that chases Nina back. Finally gets to it in front of the manual scoreboard, and Joel Guzman cruises into second base just ahead of a strong throw from left. Now, Joel Guzman's hit the ball hard three times today. That's his second hit to show for it. A two-out double, and the Revs have a man in scoring position with two outs in the fifth inning. Now, Guzman has crushed the ball all three times. The second time up, he crushed it right off of Kubiak's body. Now, if pitchers were translucent, which in those instances, I sure bet they would hope they would be, that's 3 for 3 for Guzman. Instead, he will take 2 for 3, and he's got a double now. Kevin Rivers will try and bring him around. A couple of walks for Rivers today. Kubiak, the kick in the first pitch. Rivers swings and misses a slider in the dirt, and it's nothing and one. Rivers, a former Clinton Lumber King, he would have just missed being teammates with Wellington Dotel, who's out in right field. Now the 0-1 pitch, that's a slider low, and a snap throw back to second base from Heel. Strong throw, but Guzman is in there. Dotel played about a month with the Lumber Kings in 2010 before being released, and he's been on the outlaw circuit ever since. Meanwhile, Rivers in the Seattle organization passed through Clinton for all of 2011 and then half of 2012 before being promoted to the High Desert Mavericks. 1-1 from Kubiak. There's a cut fastball, and it cuts outside. Two balls and a strike. Rivers' best season statistically, as most players have, came out in High Desert, where the scoring was as high as the desert. 20 home runs, 97 RBIs. He had 297 that year. Has a fastball just ekes outside, and it's 3-1. But consistent power for Rivers as he came away from the desert last year with Lancaster. 15 home runs and 48 driven in. 3-1 pitch, that's low and away for ball four. The third walk of the game for Kevin Rivers. And on the 90th pitch, Kubiak puts two men on with two out and a red hot rocket stepping to the plate. Three walks already for Rivers. That ties a season high for the Revs as Rocket takes breaking ball in that time, too far in for DeBrower's liking for ball one. Telvin Nash and Andres Perez also have three walks to their name in a game. Rivers joins them. The 1-0, and Rock takes low and away for ball two. Nobody loosening in the pen for Bridgeport. This appears to be Kubiak's inning, as they want to try and get in this last out so he can qualify for the decision. 2-0 pitch, that's in the dirt. Dropped by Heel, but he locates immediately. And so the count goes to three balls and no strikes. Interesting call here. See if Rocket swings away. If he takes, he brings up a good bases-loaded hitter in Chavez. 3-0. Rock takes all the way, and he takes a strike at the knees, a fastball at 88 miles an hour, and that's 3-1. Guzman on second, Rivers on first. Two outs. 4-0 Bluefish for the moment in the bottom of the fifth. Two outs. And the 3-1 pitch to Rocket is outside, ball four. Back-to-back walks, and Kubiak will have to work with the bases loaded again. And that brings Brandon Chavez back to the plate. Chavez, four at-bats with the bases loaded this year. He's had hits in two of them and driven in three runs. 300 hitter with men in scoring position and two outs. And the first pitch, Xavi laces one but foul down the left field line. Out towards the United Way section that's making its roost out there behind the Bridgeport bullpen. Chavez trying to redeem himself after striking out in a similar situation in the last inning. A lot can be forgiven with a gapper right here. 0-1, drilled foul towards the net that protects the Bridgeport dugout, and he chased Jesse Litch and about half of the Bluefish bench players back into that dugout. And so time is asked for. Kubiak and Heel will discuss signs. Right-handed arm getting loose for Bridgeport. But Kubiak, one strike away from getting out of another jam. Chavez digging in. Kubiak, the kick and the 0-2 pitch. Fastball away and just for ball one. Xavi, a switch hitter. He's batting left-handed for the third straight time tonight. Digs in, and time is asked for by the catcher, Heel. So Heel heels. And now he's ready again. 1-2 pitch coming, and time will be asked for as a ball from the bullpen. No, they got the ball. 1-2 pitch, grounded towards short. Hernandez shading to his right. Long throw coming back to first is in time by a step side retired. Well, the Revs with three two-out base runners, but they can't cash him in. No runs on one hit, no errors. Three left on base for the second straight inning. End of the fifth, your score. Bridgeport 4, York nothing on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
They leave their homes and families every day just as we do, to go to work. Yet their workday involves doing things nobody wants to do, from the mundane duty of traffic control, to the heartbreak of an accident scene, to the unknown dangers of responding to a 911 call. Police work can be a thankless role in today's society. Maple Donuts recognizes that our police force gives us their dedication to the job, and for that we owe them our thanks. Although we can't possibly express our gratitude for their choice to take on such a needed role in our community, as a small token of our appreciation, Maple Donuts proudly says, "Officer, the coffee's on us." Any on-duty officer who stops by any Maple Donuts location will receive a free cup of Maple Donuts' famous coffee. And to officers throughout the York, Lancaster, and Harrisburg areas, thank you for choosing to serve your community. Maple Donuts
taste right. Well, I finally did it. I took my dad's advice and joined his credit union.
Which one?
PSECU. I'm eligible because my dad's a member, but I joined through work.
Really? I thought you had to work for the state.
A lot of people think that, but there are lots of ways to be eligible.
I'm not really thrilled with my bank and all their fees. I need to check them out.
Definitely. It's worth the switch.
PSCCU is the credit union for you. Find your way at psccu.com/join. This credit union is federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
4-0 Bluefish as we head to the top of the sixth inning. Nina, Nunez, and Hernandez. First is Angelus Nina. Sack bunt and a ground out today. The first pitch from James Simmons is a fastball grooved right down George Street for called strike one. Simmons at 88 pitches right now. If he plays it right, he could still go two innings. 0-1 is golf foul and out of play. Down the first baseline, into the seats, where it'll go home with a lucky fan from Glendrock. Simmons, a rock of consistency in that rotation. He's gone at least six innings in 15 of his 19 starts this season. 0-2 pitch, reached out and flown out towards shallow center. Witherspoon barely has to move for it. Now he shades to his left to make the catch, one away. Simmons' season high in the pitch count is 114. That came at Bridgeport back on May 31st. In that game, the Revs would score 7 in the ninth for to win. But he's gone over the 100 pitch marker 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. And his last time out, he was one shy at 99. Translation, his night is not over by any stretch of the imagination. Luis Nunez takes a fastball, inner black, all the way for strike one. He's the K-man. He has not obliged so far today, so we get the chanting stylings of Ray Jansen from a couple of booths down as Nunez takes away for ball one. Nunez has one of the big hits of the night, that two-run single in the second on a hanging curveball. Simmons the wind and the 1-1 pitch. This one slapped foul to the screen. And it's 1-2. The crowd speaks for itself here. They want breadsticks. 1-2, low and outside. Diving stop by Erie on a slider. And it's two balls and two strikes now to Nunez, the Venezuelan national. Born in Barquisimeto, Venezuela. Time asked for. Ascended as high as AAA in the minors. He got to the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Yankees a couple of stints and then was with Gwinnett in the Braves system as he fouls another one back out of play. Over the first base side as we stay at 2-2. Statistically, his best year came in 2008 with the Tampa Yankees of the Florida State League, that's high A, where he hit 280 with 40 runs driven in. 2-2 pitch, reaches out and golfs another one foul. Now he's playing hokey pokey with his body, sticking the fanny out, but staying in the box. This will be the seventh pitch of the at-bat. As Luis Rodriguez apparently is arguing with Brian DeBrower over something or other. He's flapping his arms like a duck, and I'm not sure why. Well, we'll see if we can get an explanation on that. Video at 11. Now Nunez stands in for the seventh pitch. Simmons stares him down. Now delivers the offering. A little nubber in front of the mound. Simmons comes off. Easy throw to first base in time. So no breadsticks, but a second out for Simmons, who's now one out away from his first 1-2-3 of the night. He's been one out away a couple of times tonight. 4-0 Bluefish. Top six. And Luis Hernandez will get his fourth look at James Simmons today. The first three have gone well for him. 2-for-3 with an RBI double. And the lefty digs in. A switch hitter batting left. Simmons the wind in the first pitch. A fastball is at the belt, called strike one. Well, the bottom kind of fell out of that one. More of a changeup. At 78 miles an hour, and it's no balls and one strike. Next pitch, tried to nibble the corner, and he misses for ball one. Hernandez, another Venezuelan national. 1-1 pitch, popped him up, left side of the infield. Towns locating from third. He gives way to the shortstop Wilson today, who makes the catch to retire the side. 1-2-3 inning for Simmons. His first, he's at 99 pitches through six innings. Presumably, he could come out for another. Bluefish go in order. Middle of the sixth, your score. Bridgeport 4, York nothing on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
If you have ever been charged with a crime, you know it can be a frightening and stressful time. You have a right to legal representation that is crucial to assisting you through this difficult time. Criminal charges often carry consequences beyond fines, and often charges such as DUI can have an impact on your driver's license, employment, and automobile insurance. The law offices of Griffith, Lerman, Lutz, and Scheib can help you in these matters. We have experienced attorneys who primarily focus on these areas and are prepared to represent your interest in a diligent and vigorous manner to achieve the best possible result for you and protect your rights under the U.S. Constitution. Our experience, skills, and candid advice will guide you through this process and help you obtain the best result under the particular circumstances of a case. Call us today at 757-7602 for a free consultation or visit us at our website at gslsc.com. Griffith, Lerman, Lutz, and Scheib, 110 South Northern Way, York, Pennsylvania. Attorneys licensed in Pennsylvania and Maryland.
This is the Dan Patrick Show.
I just like to say that y'all rock, man.
Is Tom Brady now suspended?
Yes. The Associated Press says appeals court rules Patriots quarterback Tom Brady must serve four game deflate cases.
Fritzy, call for Tom Brady.
I'm on it.
And if not, Giselle. And then Robert Kraft. He's got 4 months here. What can he do in 4 months here with an appeal?
Basically, what this is basically where we were last year.
Yeah.
Dan Patrick.
Mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOIK. All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Bottom six from downtown York, 4-0. Bridgeport on top. And the first pitch coming to Brian Pounds is taken at the knees. A called strike one fastball from David Kubiak. Poundsy, a walk, and he was hit by a pitch. That's the first pitch he's seen in the zone all night. Kubiak with the 0-1, a breaking ball just above the letters. Tried for those letters, and he ends up dotting an I. And it's ball one. Kubiak, a wind and the 1-1 pitch. This one roped to short. Short hop by Hernandez. He's got it. He'll rifle the first in time, one away. Pounds solid contact, but he hit it in exactly the wrong spot. Your out-of-town scoreboard is brought to you by York Mitsubishi, as always. Top eight from New Britain, Bees 2, Sugarland 2. Bottom five from Long Island, Ducks down 4-1 against Lancaster. And bottom three from Somerset, Patriots 3, Southern Maryland 2. Brian Erie, a couple of strikeouts today. The first pitch to him, he takes a fastball, outer black for called strike one. Erie takes off the cap. Airs out his head. Now he sticks it back on, and he walks back in to the batter's box. The 0-1 from Kubiak, curveball that rode in on him. And it's ball one. Prime twilight time in York. Sky mostly a darker shade of blue. And here he takes a strike. Outer black. Fastball. It catches corner, and it's one ball and two strikes. Just hints of light as we're almost half past the 8 o'clock hour. The 1-2 pitch is golfed foul in towards the bleachers on the first base side. Once it comes to a rest and it is cool enough to touch, a fan from Fawn Grove picks it up and will take it home. Kubiak with the rock and the roll. And he tried for that corner again on a fastball and missed it this time. Count goes to two balls and two strikes. 107 pitches for Kubiak now. As the Bluefish have a man warming behind him. 2-2 pitch, big hook, and a slow roller towards third. Charged by Cuevas. He makes the throw across his body and over to first in time. Two away. That's Paul Demney, who's been getting loose for a couple of innings. Michael Click has been warming up in the Revolution bullpen. Whether or not he comes out for the seventh, I suppose, depends on whether James Simmons feels like he can go again. 99 pitches for Simmons, but taking into account the heat, and that might be it for him. Josh Wilson takes the first pitch low and away, a slider for ball one. Wilson is 0 for 2 today, a strikeout and a flyout. The Revs with just three hits off of David Kubiak. 1-0, and a line drive to second, caught by Nunez. Died on him pretty quickly, but he's able to lower the mitt and make the catch. Well, the Revs go in order, and David Kubiak's got himself a quality start. Six scoreless innings for him. Revs go in order. End of the sixth, your score, Bridgeport 4, York nothing. Daryl Henry will take you home here on the WOYK Revs Radio Network.
Did you send that email?
No, the server's down.
Again? That's the third time this week. Did you call support?
Sure, great hold music for the last hour.
There's got to be a better way.
There is. Let SoCo Business Solutions maintain your current IT environment, evaluate your current systems, or provide support that's local and responsive. Contact SoCo at 717-505-8080 and let us be your IT solutions provider. That's 717-505-8080 or online at SoCoBusinessSolutions.com.
Come and celebrate 10 years of York Revolution Baseball with the Celebrate York Series presented by Memorial Hospital. The series honors significant contributions from York, Pennsylvania's most notable events and favorite citizens with giveaways every Friday night home game. The series continues on Friday, September 2nd with a bobblehead giveaway of York's favorite mascot, Downtown. Visit YorkRevolution.com for more details. It's the Celebrate York Series, proudly presented by Memorial Hospital for the York Revolution's 10th anniversary season.
Ugh, Wednesdays are the worst. I've got to get the kids to school on time to get to work, then it's just one long day of meetings. But hey, at least I don't have to worry about making dinner.
Kids eat free with People's Bank. Save money at every Wednesday home game.
So now when the Revs are in town, I just pull into a People's Bank, pick up that week's coupon, and dinner is done. Revolution Wednesdays? Awesome. Revolution!
Thanks to People's Bank, kids eat free at every Wednesday home game. No need to be a People's Bank customer. Just pick up your coupon at any People's Bank branch and do dinner at People's Bank Park. One coupon per child per game.
On air, online, and on your smartphone. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Well, I'll try to sit upright after that tub of ice cream I ate during the fifth and sixth innings. 4-0 Bridgeport in the lead as we start the seventh. Michael Click is on.
You're going to be fused to your seat the rest of the night.
Might have put that stand out of business over there with the amount that they forked over. Well, Click is on here as we start the seventh inning. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. James Simmons, 6 innings, 4 runs, 10 hits. Didn't walk any, though. Struck out 5. And Erie will meet with Click and discuss signals once before beginning this inning. It'll be Andy Chavez for the Bluefish. The Revs, over the last 23 offensive innings, the last three nights, just 3 runs on a combined 10 hits in those 23 innings. 2 runs on 3 hits in the win on Wednesday night. 1 run on 4 hits last night, being shut out on 3 hits so far tonight. And it seems like on the occasions that they do hit it hard, it's at least half the time anyway, right at somebody. And at the same time, David Kubiak, very good tonight, has command of everything. His curveball was outstanding. Well, maybe still is. They don't have anybody throwing. Chavez leading off the seventh. Click is ready to go. His first pitch of the inning is up high. Fastball at 91. Chavez 2 for 3 tonight. Got his average up to 333 now. 19th year pro. 1-0. And it missed outside, a fastball. was sidelined about the first month of the season with a hamstring injury. And then for a while he was playing but not running well, but now he's pretty much at full form. Here's a fastball for a called strike. 2-1.
New Britain's looking at him saying, at that time when he was hitting but couldn't run very well, and saying, wait, you can sit him?
Now the 2-1. Man, that's high and wide. Yeah, they have no such luxuries.
Mm-mm.
The team that we just saw. Bluefish, for a lot of years, always had more bench position players than any other team. Here's a liner to left center and a base hit. And Rocket hustling over, cuts it off, spins and fires. Chavez trying for two, and he dives in ahead of the tag. Chavez receiving a strong one-hop throw on the spin around from Rocket, but reaching for the tag, and Endy dove to the front corner of the bag. He's got himself a leadoff double and is 3-for-4 in the night.
A classic showdown between gutsy base runner and all-around solid fielder. Rocket made every effort to get that ball in, but the throw just ran out of gas over the last quarter section of its path. If it keeps with the thrust, then Chavez is probably out, but takes a couple of bounces and slows down too much to get him.
Now Jose Cuevas. There's the pitch from Click, and he swings and misses on some high gas. Well, Bridgeport, back to the bench players. When Willie Upshaw was managing, it seemed like they always had like your National League amount of position players on the bench. Five seemed to always be the number. But they didn't have inactives. Here's the 0-1, and it's sent the other way, foul toward the corner, into the right field corner. They just had fewer pitchers, and they would leave the starters out there for longer. Seemed like they were always going seven innings as opposed to maybe six that most teams average. New Britain did not have such luxuries we just saw. Click fires and spiked it. Brian Erie wearing that one off the chest protector.
I got an update for you from the Bronx, Darrell. Alex Rodriguez in his first at-bat, an RBI double. Batting third, so it came in the first inning.
Well, isn't that exciting?
Well, it is for our fan who's there.
Click the 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Slider down and away. Erie will put on the tag to complete it. For Bridgeport, by the way, they have three position players on their bench tonight. Excuse my reach, Will.
Well,
one of our guests on that Yankee Stadium trip tonight, Facebook posted how fantastic it was that there was a downpour right when A-Rod and his family were out on the field being honored. I wonder if our suite is booing. Here's Sean Burrows. And Click with the fastball. It's a called strike. Trying to work around the leadoff double. It's 4-0 Bridgeport here in the seventh. Burrows struck out the first two times, but then homered in the fifth, a solo shot to right. 0-1 is down by his ankles. He jumps out of the way. Parked it out near Cannonball, first of the year. And I think that probably speaks to the injuries that he's dealt with this season, the fact that it's only his first home run. He's a big guy and has always had some pop. Click, the 1-1, And he shoots a ground foul the other way at third. Burroughs finished last year with Long Island, but started the year with Bridgeport. He just edged out his former and now again teammate Wellington Dotel for last year's Atlantic League batting title. That goes to show you the type of hitter he can be when healthy. Click, the 1-2, and a foul back again to the left of the screen. That came back hot.
And the kind of danger he can be to all those within the immediate vicinity of him swinging.
The ninth overall pick of the Padres in 98 out of high school, Woodrow Wilson High School in Long Beach, 7 years in the majors. Padres, Rays, Diamondbacks, and Twins. 1-2 again, and he lines it right to third, pounds up the ladder to make the grab. Brian pounds a jump and spears it in the pocket of his glove, two outs. Well, Burroughs hit it right on the nose, but lines out. Now with two down, Wellington Dotel will dig in. He's 0 for 3. Pop up, ground out, strikeout. Have the Boy Scout on-field camp out and sleepover after the game tonight. Click the pitch, swing and a miss. And a slider there that got Dotel to reach and one hand after it. Now Dotel will ask for time and back out. Tomorrow night at 6:30, Tyrell Harris against Jonathan Abilideo. Sunday at 1, Tony Pena against Ross Seton. There's the 0-1. And that misses down and outside. Click's been known as the hard fastball guy, but a lot of sliders in this outing tonight. Two of them to start Dotel's at bat. He now steps off. Former Temple Owl, blessed with the good arm. A 1-1 and a foul back to the net. He ramped that heater up at 94, 1-2. Click from Media, Pennsylvania, the Philly suburb.
Certain ways, when you go to Philadelphia from here, you pass through Media when you take the back roads.
I love back roads, Will.
So do I, Daryl.
1-2 pitch, that's in the dirt, and Erie blocks it.
I'll tell you, I enjoy the back roads, especially when it's a sunny day, but usually just when it's day. I think when it's nighttime, I prefer to take the direct interstate because there's less of a chance of deer.
Well, it's very well thought out by you, I would agree.
Followed that principle going to Aberdeen a couple of times last week.
Now the 2-2, fastball missed away. That one at 96. I'm not sure if we've discussed that, Will. How was your trip down there?
Oh, it was very nice. Cal Ripken World Series going on. It was I pulled duty on six of the games there, two each Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, so when you guys were down in New Britain.
Payoff pitch, a swing and a foul tip at the plate.
And Japan ended up winning the championship. They beat the team from the Pacific Northwest in the championship game of that Cal Ripken World Series. But I told you this story off the air. The most exciting game was the last one that I ended up calling. It was Puerto Rico and Mexico. Of course, Mexico, massive favorites in this game. And with crowds on both sides just absolutely loving it, Puerto Rico pulls off a miracle 7-5 upset. And 3 minutes later, as the Iron Birds game ends on the same, you know, site, Cal Ripken Universe there, the fireworks start going off. It's a moment that those kids will never forget so long as they live. Neither will any of us.
Click will try it again on a full count. And a swing and a miss. He got him upstairs. Fastball at 94 to blow him away. Two strikeouts in the inning. Click works around the leadoff double. No runs, one hit, and one left. Seventh inning stretch here at People's Bank Park. Bluefish still lead it 4-0.
At HealthSouth, rehabilitation is all we do. So it just makes sense that HealthSouth Rehabilitation Hospital of York will help you get home sooner. HealthSouth is the largest rehabilitation provider in the country. We provide 3 hours of therapy 5 days a week, frequent physician visits, and registered nurses 24/7. It's total team-based care that is squarely focused on your recovery. After an illness, injury, or surgery, choose HealthSouth, providing a higher level of care to the York community for more than 30 years. HealthSouthYork.com.
Ross Brothers Barbecue is serving up the hits every Saturday night this season at People's Bank Park. Stop by Arch Street Eats on the third base corner and load up on delicious, fresh-made local barbecue. All of Ross' sauces and sides are made from scratch daily. All meats are smoked for an authentic barbecue done right. Ross Brothers also offers drive-thru, dine-in, and carry-out from the restaurant at 3096 Carlisle Road in Dover, as well as delivery and full-service catering. Ross Brothers can cater any sized event from fundraisers to graduation parties to weddings. Ross Brothers Barbecue every Saturday night at People's Bank Park.
Hear that? It's the sound of summer. Sound nice? Call Kona Ice. We do it all. Schools, sporting events, parties, both corporate and birthday. You name it, we'll be there. We bring the party to you. If you need a little bit of fun in your life, we're the shaved ice truck for you. Oh, and we fundraise too. This summer, cool down with Kona Ice. Give us a call at 1-800-KONA-ICE or visit us online at www.kona-ice.com. Kona Ice. Flavor our world.
The radio home of the Revs. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the seventh inning, Revs trail 4-0. Bluefish go to their bullpen. Right-hander Paul Demney is the new pitcher after Kubiak went six scoreless. Top of the order, and Travis Witherspoon will lead things off. Kubiak, six scoreless, only three hits. Struck out eight. Walked five, but was able to dodge those five walks with only the three hits allowed. First pitch to Witherspoon is over for a strike. He is 0 for 3 tonight. Revs being out hit 11-3. And now Kubiak will look for his bullpen to hold it. Demney a 3.04 ERA coming in. And Witherspoon tries to bunt his way on toward third. A bare hand pickup and the throw made by Cuevas charging in. Third baseman handles the bunt try. And at first look from up here, I don't think he had a great grip on it. It looked like it was rolling around in his hand, but he was able to guide the throw across. Demney retires the first man he faces. 30 outings, 2-1 with a 3.04 ERA. Here's Jared Mitchell. Demney, a ton of walks, but a ton of strikeouts. Ton being the exact number, I believe. Pitch to Mitchell is over for a strike. 27 innings now with that out. 23 walks, but 37 strikeouts. Only 21 hits in 27 innings, so he's been able to minimize the damage by the poor control sometimes. The 0-1 to Mitchell. And a swing and a miss on a fastball. Mitchell 0 for 3 tonight. And again, the Revs only with those three hits. Joel Guzman on deck has two of those. Demney ready. And the 0-2. And a foul back off the net. Demney, a former 15th round pick of the Braves back in 07, didn't sign, and then the Nationals took him in the 6th round in 08. spent some time coming up in the Nats system. 0-2. Swinging a foul tip. Not held. That in and out of the glove of Heel. Demney drafted by the Braves from high school, went to junior college, and then the Nats called his name several rounds earlier. Made it to AAA with them. Appeared in one game at AA Bowie with the Orioles this year. And then four games in the Can-Am League, and then ended up in this league, which, given his track record, is where he should be. He deals. And a check swing on a slider. Appeal to third. No go. 1-2 to Mitchell. Before this season, his whole career spent in the Nats system, making it to AAA. 27-year-old from Texas, East Bernard, Texas. 1-2, and a swing and a drive, foul and left. Well, Kubiak, impressive tonight. He was in the spotlight, just like the Stage Deli. Has the spotlight on outstanding soup, salads, and sandwiches. For daily specials, including smoothies and catering, Facebook search for Stage Deli on George, or visit them on North George Street next to the Strand Capitol Theater. There's a ball down and in by Mitchell's feet, 2-2.
So there's a bonus for you, Darren.
Oh. Yeah. Well, he deserves it.
Oh, yes.
Two, two. And a foul tip back to the net.
Darrell, I got another update for you from the minor leagues, and this one is significant in any right as Francisco Mejia, the Indians prospect with the Lynchburg Hillcats, high A, has now hit 49 straight games. It's a season high in the minors this year. Duh.
Pitch is grounded toward the middle and a base hit for Mitchell. He pulls it to the right of second into right center. Big turn. Oh, they throw behind him and he's back in standing up. Mitchell with the one out single, the Revs with their fourth hit.
And I would mention that anyway, but considering what the dates are in Revolution history, it seems to tie in pretty well. Chris Ashby, of course, tying and breaking the Atlantic League hit streak record with his 27th this day in 2008 and his 28th tomorrow in 2008, and both in Revs wins against Southern Maryland.
It was incredible. First pitch to Joel is swung on and looped foul the other way. You know, an untold part of that history, nobody really knows this, but there was another team in the league that the day that he broke it called into question what the previous record actually was. Pitch to Guzman is swung on and missed, a high fastball. And it was clearly right there on the stat database at the time, but because the previous record holder had been involved in a doubleheader the year that he had set it, it looked like, or I think he played two different positions in one game or something, and it split the stats. Here's a tap foul along the third base line. Cuevas over to backhand it. At any rate, it looked like, if you were to go back and count it up, it looked different than what it was. It looked like he had a longer streak, so they tried to say, oh no, he's not breaking the record yet, but our statistical confirmations that day put that to rest rather quickly.
And even if it hadn't been been overturned, he still goes out and makes it a 31-game hitting streak. So there.
There's a foul tip straight back. But unfortunately, on the final game of the streak, there was a game at Somerset, and he had a hit that was initially scored a hit, and then they signaled from the Patriot dugout that they didn't think it should be a hit, and they changed it to an error. And we left that night thinking he was over, the streak was done. Next day, they changed it back to a hit, but really kind of soiled the end of that run, unfortunately. Here's a swing and a miss on a slider, and Demney the strikeout of Guzman for out number two.
Well, Chris Ashby, still a record that stands in the Atlantic League, a 31-game hitting streak and an instrumental part in the Revs' first playoff team in 2008.
The way they took off when they added him, it was an offensive struggle in the first 2 months of that season. The week before Ashby, they added Kennard Jones. He became a great leadoff hitter. And then adding Ashby, the three-hitter. Mitchell runs, pitch outside on Rivers, and the throw sails into center. Mitchell has a stolen base. So he slides in at second with his 19th in 20 tries with York. But yeah, the instant impact those two guys made. The Revs went from really struggling offensively to being probably the most scary offense in the league the rest of the season. Allowed everybody else to fall into place and their role in the lineup. It was just a powerful, powerful machine the rest of the way.
Of course, similar to what Witherspoon and Mitchell have brought to this Revolution team, establishing themselves at the top of the order.
No doubt. 1-0 to Rivers, swings and fouls it back into the net. Revs trailing here tonight, 4-0 in the seventh. Trying to get on the board. They left them loaded in the fourth and fifth. On the 1-1, and a changeup just missed away. Stretch from Demney, 2-1 to Rivers. It slides inside, and a 3-1 count. Mm. By the way, our Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care home run contest tonight, failed to mention Lisa Coble is our contestant. Good luck, Lisa. If the Revs go yard, you would be our winner. You and only you. The 3-1, and there's a slider for a called strike. It's interesting, behind in the count, he threw the slider with a four-run lead, but some guys have such good feel for the breaking stuff, they feel they can locate that just as well. And 3-2, missed high, back to the fastball, and he missed.
Four walks.
Yeah, wow, four walks for Rivers, no at-bats all night. And that'll tie a team record for a single game. Chad Tracy did it. He was the most recent to do it a couple of years back. Now here's Michael Rocket. And Luis Rodriguez coming to the mound, the skipper. Well, they had just gotten somebody up in their bullpen, I believe, so this is just a meeting.
Stall for time, as much time as possible to get the lefty loose. It's Patterson who's warming up, and no pure lefties coming up in the Revs order for some time, but Brandon Chavez are, I'm guessing, going to try and turn him around and make him bat right-handed if Rocket continues the inning.
Well, the Revs had not had four walks in a game by one player since 2007 until Chad Tracy did it at the end of the 2013 season, but beg your pardon, he was not the most recent to do it. Eric Patterson did it in a game last August against Southern Maryland. Tracy did it 2 years before that, and in 2007, Ramon Navarre and Luis Cotto both did it. Pitch to Rocket, hit him up by the face. A slider from Demney, and he started to duck, and it got him up near the left cheek. And he immediately put his hands up to his face and went running away from the plate. Chong out right away. Polo down from third. And it was a slow move from Rocket, who it's almost like, well, the slider looked like it almost backed up and didn't slide. But it was like he thought it was a curveball that was slower maybe and would break bigger, and it just didn't break the way he thought. And he's got a bloody nose. They bring a towel out to him. And that's going to be the end of his night. And hopefully it's just a bloody nose and not worse. He's walking fine under his own power, a straight line to the dugout, holding the towel up to his face by himself. But a hit by pitch near the face, there's nothing scarier than that. Man, oh man. Rede Rodriguez will pinch run and stay in to play left. Now you could hear it smack up here. It's sickening. And hopefully no damage done other than some blood, although sometimes when the nose bleeds, there's a good chance the nose is broken, but I suppose if that's all he would end up with from that, I mean, it could be a lot worse.
He'll take it.
But hopefully he doesn't even have that. The good news is he walk by himself on a straight line to the dugout. We'll keep our fingers crossed for him. Bases loaded for Brandon Chavez. And I'm not sure anybody has been more valuable to this team than Rocket this season. Pitch to Chavez is outside, 1-0.
Not just the average has been climbing up to 300 this week, but the ability to plug him in at every position, pretty much. He's played six different ones, all the outfield positions, and then the three on the left side of the infield.
Well, thankfully, I mean, the other thing, it was a slider at 79. Thankfully, it wasn't a fastball at like 95. Pitch to Chavez is swung on and missed. Bases loaded, tying run at the plate.
Don't even want to think about that.
No. Mace looking back at the dugout bench to check on Rocket. Fletch as well, both there on the top step in front of where Rocket took his seat. Now the 1-1, and a swing and a foul tip into the glove. Good rip from Chavez. Demney's fastball is in the 90s, that one at 91. Chavez a fly out, strike out, ground out tonight. That's down 4-0. Demney nods yes, here's the stretch. And the 1-2, that missed the corner away. Certainly doesn't need to make it all up on one swing. Revs trying to break up the shutout, get this thing a little bit closer. Countless comeback wins late this season. They're trying to build something to start with. Here's the stretch. And now the 2-2. Fastball down and in. Good eye. Couldn't have missed by much. It's a full count. Both runners, or all three runners, can get some leeway here with two outs. Bases loaded. Demney's 29th pitch of the inning coming up. 3-2. And a swing and a drive the other way and left, but fading foul into the left field corner. Chavez gave it a ride, but just a little bit off the mark when it left the bat. Let's see if he can straighten that out. Now Rocket grabbing his bats, walking up to the clubhouse under his own power, no longer holding the towel to his face, so the bleeding must have stopped. And everything so far, good news, knock on wood. Talking to his bullpen teammates, pitch to Chavez, bounce right side, cut off at first by Burrows, and he dumps it off at short to end the inning. Burrows ranging way over from first, the former third baseman gloving it and dumping it off at second for the inning-ending 3-6 force. No runs, one hit. Revs leave them loaded for the third time tonight, third time in four innings, and 12 total left on. We go to the eighth, still a 4-0 Bridgeport lead.
Hey, Revs fans, seasons come and go, but French fries are forever. Bricker's Famous French Fries are back for their 10th season as a member of the Revs team. Come and celebrate the team's 10th anniversary with those fan-favorite fries and chicken tenders. You can find them, as always, behind center field next to the playground at People's Bank Park. Call 717-792-4959 or visit online at brickersfries.com. When you want French fries, nothing is better than Bricker's.
Money and business are essential to the strength of a community. So is cheering and celebration and music and fun. That's why York Revolution games, concerts, youth sports, special events, and more happen at a place called People's Bank Park. People's Bank has been serving York County for more than 150 years. Always cheering, always celebrating, always committed to the things that make York County great. And to you having a great time at People's Bank Park. People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
York's Community Hotel since 1925 is locally owned once again. Where else but the Yorktown Hotel? Our dedicated staff looks forward to welcoming your out-of-town guests and catering your next event in our elegant Roaring Twenties Ballroom. Enjoy the tastes of York in the hotel's off-center grill, where we partner with locally owned favorites including Green Bean Roasting Company, York City Pretzel, Wolfgang Candy, Liquid Hero Brewery, and Mudhook Brewery. Come see what all the hullabaloo is about at the Yorktown Hotel. The Yorktown is proud to be the host hotel of the York Revolution.
All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Four nothing Bridgeport. We go to the eighth inning. And Jose Arredondo, the new pitcher for York, pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Jose Heel will lead things off for Bridgeport. 2-for-3 tonight with a run. First pitch of the inning is right over the plate for ball one. Heel now 6-for-9 against the Revs in a couple of series this season. Arredondo's been going well. Here's a swing and a grounder off the end of the bat to short. Wilson a step right. He's in front of it. Throws to first. And Heel was still only halfway down the line, chucking to the ground what might very well be a broken bat. Brought to you by Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. One away here in the eighth. Arredondo 0-1, but he's got a 1.80 ERA in his 20 outings. Just a base runner per inning, 20 innings, 16 hits, 4 walks. He struck out 19. Here's Galvez, who looks at one down and away. Galvez 1-for-3, a bunt single and a run in the second. He swings here, grounds one sharply and pounds a great backhand pick. Oh, and the throw in the dirt, Kevin Rivers makes the backhand pick at first base. Fantastic on both ends of the play. And Galvez hit it hard, but Pounds reaching on the backhand. made a clean pick, and then Rivers did the same on the throw. Two down here in the top of the eight.
And they get extra points for degree of difficulty.
No Russian judge in this booth. Here's Angelis Nina as Arredondo misses inside. Nina 0 for 2 with a sack bunt.
See, it was never the Russian judges. It was always the Soviet bloc countries or some other random country they got to.
Here's a liner in right field. Mitchell tiptoes to his right. He's right there. And a 1-2-3 top of the eight for Jose Arredondo. Got his ninth straight scoreless appearance. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Revs trail the Bluefish 4-0.
The more we help the ones in need, the more progress our community will make.
By focusing on quality education, income opportunities, and basic health care,
all of York County can have access to the building blocks of a good quality of life.
Together, we can load the bases for our community
and hit a home run.
Give generously to the 2016 United Way Community Fund.
Find out more and give now at unitedway-york.org.
Does your wealth advisor know how you take your coffee? At Smith, Mayer & Little Wealth Advisory Group, we genuinely get to know our clients, from their interests, goals, and dreams, right down to how they like their coffee. By understanding our clients on a personal level, we help them make wise financial decisions. In us, you will find a trusted confidant dedicated to your financial success. Smith, Mayer & Little, a wealth of knowledge about wealth. Get to know us over a cup of coffee or visit us at financialjava.com.
Janie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSC, FINRA, and SIPC.
Come and celebrate 10 years of York Revolution Baseball with the Celebrate York Series presented by Memorial Hospital. The series honors significant contributions from York, Pennsylvania's most notable events and favorite citizens with giveaways every Friday night home game. The series continues on Friday, September 2nd with a bobblehead giveaway of York's favorite mascot, Downtown. Visit YorkRevolution.com for more details. It's the Celebrate York Series, proudly presented by Memorial Hospital for the York Revolution's 10th anniversary season.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Four nothing game, bottom of the eighth, Revs trail. The York County Solid Waste Authority urges residents to properly dispose of household medications. That's why they put secure medication drop boxes in 16 police departments. Drop old meds off for free. Learn more at www.ycswa.com. Garbage is power. Is it words to live by?
Because I'm the trash man. Yeah, I'm the trash man.
Lefty Jimmy Patterson, the new pitcher for Bridgeport here in the bottom of the eighth. Brian Pounds to lead things off. First pitch of the inning is right down the chute for a strike. Pounds 0 for 1 with a walk and a hit by pitch. He's only got one at bat. Kevin Rivers has none officially. As Patterson steps off, the Revs have drawn six walks in this game and two hit by pitches, but only four hits. Here's the 0-1 and a foul back off the netting. Patterson's made 14 starts this year. This is his 12th outing in relief. 1-4 with a 4.10 ERA. He has a sign from his catcher heel. Here's the 0-2. And a swing and a fly foul off to the right. Patterson's second year with Bridgeport. Last year, 14 appearances, all in relief. This year, 14 starts, and now 12 in relief. Now the southpaw ready. Another 0-2, and a swing and a miss. Got him on a slider in the dirt. Tag applied. and one away. We'll pause for station identification. This is Revolution Radio.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
At one down, here's Brian Erie looking for his first Revs hit. Revs trail 4-0 here in the bottom of the eighth. Erie tonight, 2 Ks and a ground out. Patterson kicks and delivers and just a bit outside, straight to the backstop.
He tried the corner and missed.
Ball one. From the stretch, kicks and fires, and a swing and a miss. Good rip from Erie on that fastball. Patterson, a former Rays farmhand, that's who he came up with. Product of Arizona State. He's from Chandler, Arizona.
So many great ball players from there.
1-1, man, that missed outside. Bo Vaughn at the top of the list.
Oh, yeah.
Top of our list, for sure. It's an 18th round pick of Tampa Bay back in 2010. And the 2-1. Swing and a miss, a fastball.
For Montgomery Biscuit.
Yeah. Got some ties there.
Yes, we do.
Keith Castillo, Stacy.
Mm-hmm. Well, she was who I was thinking of.
Our former marketing director who's now there. He's the 2-2. Swing and a miss, a fastball away. And Patterson, two up, two down on strikeouts here in the eighth.
Got a couple of Biscuit bobbleheads on the shelf back at the OYK studios. Chris Archer and the Biscuit itself.
Oh, we have a Desmond Jennings one,
oh,
too.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yep, she brings gifts when she visits. She would not want to hear us complain about heat.
Oh, no.
Working in Montgomery. There's Josh Wilson, who's 0 for 3 tonight. Patterson, mostly a reliever in his career, and a breaking ball over for a strike on Wilson.
I will say this, the year and a half I spent in Georgia, I never got to experience the height of summer, you know, July, early August. I was up north for all that. I did the rich person thing, summering in the north.
Now swinging a tip foul behind the plate.
But what I do remember is moving back there after my summer in Kalamazoo, Michigan. And I rolled into town at 11:30 at night in the middle of August. And it was about as hot as it was today.
Yeah.
And humid. The heat down there just hits you like a brick wall.
Makes you want to go out and get a burrito, doesn't it? Didn't you have a burrito place there that you love?
Yeah.
Or something else very heavy. Here's a foul back off the screen.
Well, in Kalamazoo, we had two fellas. This rap place and all sorts of, you know, different college-type wraps, including one, they put tater tots in the wrap with, like, barbecue sauce and chicken and many a nights there after games that summer.
Mm-mm. Another 0-2, and that dives down low. Still a 4-0 Bridgeport lead here in the eighth.
What about you? You're a York local here. What's the big burrito place that everybody really likes to go to?
Well, they didn't pay for the mentions, but...
Oh, okay. Well, what, should we hold them hostage for that, then?
Maybe.
You can tell me at the break.
Credit them. It was the 1-2. And a foul out of play, first base side. Now, in all honesty, I mean, you have your couple of national chains, and then, you know, there's a local chain, if you will. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you go to it at Market.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Of course. I was there just yesterday.
Yeah, yeah.
They've started putting fries in the burrito now.
Well, now we're getting crazy. Here's the 1-2. And a pop-up foul out of play again, first base side.
Putting fries and things, that's influence from another restaurant who hasn't paid for mentions either. But it's Pittsburgh-based. It starts with a P, and it rhymes with him, Monty Brothers.
We could do what... Well, the... I don't want to start the story if we go to the ninth. It's Patterson, the 1-2 again, and a liner down the line in left, and it is just foul off the end of the bat of Wilson, and it sounded like he cracked it, and he'll head over for New Lumber. But back in the day, on Phillies radio, Whitey Ashburn would get hungry late in the game, and he would mention two of his favorite listeners who were tuned in by the last name of a local pizza shop, Plain and Pepperoni. So they would deliver pizza to the booth, and the business office didn't like it so much because it wasn't a paying sponsor. So he would say, you know, can we get some Celebrese pizza down here at the stadium? They didn't like that, so... That's when he started tailoring it and saying, shout out to the Celebrese twins who are listening, Plain and Pepperoni.
Ah.
And that's how he's still got his pizza in the booth. And here's a swing and a miss. A slider from Patterson gets Wilson on strikes. Jimmy Patterson comes in and strikes out the side in the bottom of the eighth. The Revs' offensive frustrations tonight continue as we head to the ninth inning. It is Bridgeport 4, York nothing.
Wednesdays are the worst. I've got to get the kids to school in time to get to work, then it's just one long day of meetings. But hey, at least I don't have to worry about making dinner.
Kids eat free with People's Bank. Save money at every Wednesday home game.
So now when the Revs are in town, I just pull into a People's Bank, pick up that week's coupon, and dinner is done. Revolution Wednesdays? Awesome. Revolution!
Thanks to People's Bank, kids eat free at every Wednesday home game. No need to be a People's Bank customer. Just pick up your coupon at any People's Bank branch and do dinner at People's Bank Park. One coupon per child per game.
Pain doesn't take Sunday off. Neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
Struggling to find quality IT help for your business? Tired of being sold solutions from companies helping their bottom line more than yours? Sick of your calls being answered overseas? SoCo Business Solutions is your answer to maintain your current environment, redesign your infrastructure, provide local responsive support, and keep your data safe. Contact SoCo at 717-505-8080 and let us be your IT solutions provider. That's 717-505-8080 or online at socobusinesssolutions.com.
The Revolution plays here. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the ninth, 4-0 Bridgeport. Luis Perdomo is on in relief. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Click Arredondo and now Perdomo out of the bullpen tonight. Luis Nunez will lead off. By the way, they're doing our WOYK Flying Feet Olympics promo here in the ballpark, which reminds me, tomorrow we've got another something new here on the station at noon, Olympic golf.
Oh.
Play-by-play. If you've ever wanted to hear golf on the radio, tomorrow at noon until roughly 3, we'll have coverage of men's golf, which is in the Olympics for the first time in 100 years.
100 years?
100 years. It was Luis Nunez who takes low.
You're talking about one of the more ancient sports in sport.
Hard to believe.
Hence my flabbergastedness.
Baseball and softball return in 4 years. That's good.
I would hope they would. They're having it over in Tokyo. big game there.
There's a check swing from Nunez. It was low. They appeal it. He did not go. 2-0. But yeah, we've got Olympic golf tomorrow. First ever golf play-by-play on WOYK.
History in the making.
Presented by Flying Feet. Tonight in Rio, tonight at 10. Tune in for that. Oh, look out. High and tight as Nunez goes backpedaling away. Well, unfortunately, the women's soccer team lost in the quarterfinal that we aired earlier today. Probably get some swimming play-by-play tonight at 10 o'clock. 3-0, and he's backing up as Perdomo threw it, and it was in the dirt. A four-pitch walk here to begin the nine.
Michael Phelps due for any events tonight?
Yeah, he's got more coming up. I think they're tonight. If not tonight, tomorrow. But I was completely hooked on watching what he was doing last night. Here's Hernandez at the top of the order. He takes a strike. Finished the 200 medley with gold, and just over half an hour later had to swim his next heat.
Oh, and he blows him out of the water.
Yep. It was a ball down low, 1-1.
Oh, I saw this great headline from Clickhole, which is one of the Onion's partners, and it said that Michael Phelps almost has enough gold medals that he can trade them in for a bike. I guess 25 is the threshold or something.
It was a swing and a miss. Good slider from Perdomo. 1-2. He had to hustle off the medal stand last night to get to his next semifinal. Pitch. And a shot at second on a short hop. Chavez gobbled it up, then lost the grip, and his throw to first will be late. It was a one-hop short hop, and he had it ranging to his left initially, but then it slipped out of his grasp, and he inadvertently kicked it away when chasing it over toward the first baseline. And by the time he recovered and made the throw, Hernandez was on base. Well, scored an error. Brian DeBrower out there checking the ball for scuff marks, and they'll toss it aside after Chavez may have gotten a cleat on it. Oh, an error charge. It's first and second with nobody out. And here is Anthony Giansanti, who went into the game in center in the bottom of the seventh for Chavez. First pitch is down and away. Endy went 3-for-4 tonight, and they gave him the rest of the night off. Giansanti is first at bat, hitting at 237, does have 6 home runs. Pitch, swing, and a nubber. First base line, Perdomo over, a bare hand pickup, and he'll aim it on to first for the out. Works like a swinging bunt. Both runners move up, second and third with one away. Jose Cuevas to the plate. It's 1-for-4, a first inning single. I was all upset on Tuesday morning. We weren't going to be able to air the women's soccer semifinal because Somerset has us playing an 11 a.m. game that day.
I know how much you love those.
A conflict, but now there is no semifinal, unfortunately, for the U.S. women, so it's a moot point. Infield is in. First pitch to Cuevas is down and away. Also tomorrow at 10 a.m., the season premiere, a 10-episode miniseries of Undeniable with Joe Buck, which is back on the station. Here's a bounce foul behind the plate. Brett Favre is the guest on the initial show, and Rich Eisen had Buck on the other day, and they had some samples of the interview, and a very entertaining 1 hour tomorrow morning at 10. Joe Buck sits down with Brett Favre on the first episode of the 10-part series. Saturday mornings on our station. Here's a bouncer to second, one big hop to Chavez. He'll look the lead runner back and throw over to first. Two down, he holds Nunez at third and Hernandez at second. Revs trail 4-0 here in the ninth, and Perdomo trying to work a scoreless inning and keep it there.
Well, no Phelps at least right now in the swimming, but another American's just taking home some glory. Maya DiRado, 200 backstroke gold medalist for the Americans. Collegiate swimmer out of Stanford, and she just won it. So congratulations to Maya, who on her Twitter says she's a pizza eater and Just Dance winner and regular at Jason's, a popular eatery in Palo Alto.
Sean Burroughs, swing and a miss. He trying to kill it, and Perdomo snapped off a slider there. Burroughs 1-for-4, a home run back in the fifth. His first of the year. Perdomo the stretch, the 0-1, and a bouncer right side. It's going to find the hole into the outfield. One run home. Here comes Hernandez, and no throw in. And it's a two-run single bounced through the right side hole for Sean Burroughs. He's driven in three on the night, and Bridgeport now leads it 6-0.
I stand corrected, Darrell. Michael Phelps did swim in the 100-meter butterfly. He finished in a three-way tie for the silver medal.
Ah.
How does that even happen in swimming? Ties between two people. Three?
It's Wellington Dotel who takes low. Yeah. Last night, Simone Manuel tied for gold with one other as Dotel swings and misses, 1-1. Three-way tie,
that's
unheard of.
Remarkable.
A 1-1, swing and a miss. Good fastball.
See earlier today, Ryan Lochte thinks that Phelps is going to come back for 2020.
Yep, heard that.
I mean, why not?
Yes, tonight, are they, like, making up some more silver medals down there hurriedly? Is a tip foul at the plate?
I'm not sure. I figure they got to have a lot of, contingency plans. Do the medals, are they engraved with a specific event, or is it just a general medal? Because if it is, you just go into your stock of silver medals. And
here's a grounder smoked the other way, base hit. Now Burroughs up to second, Dotel is on. They had him play the pool, and he inside outed it sharply right past second where Chavez would be much of the time. Now the inning stays alive. Bluefish with their 13th hit tonight. Jose Hill coming up. I'm sure Phelps was very disappointed that it was only silver on the butterfly tonight. Well, we'll hear all about it at 10 here on our station as Perdomo fires a strike.
Meanwhile, we got a screenshot of Katie Ledecky in the 800 freestyle. Picture secretariat at the Belmont in 1973, and that's what Katie Ledecky is doing in the pool in Rio right now.
Pitch is a slider called strike.
Ooh, lordy. Not just doing that to the other swimmers, but also to the world record mark.
Yeah. Leaving them in the dust.
Or the chlorine.
0-2, and that's down and away. Heel is 2-for-4 tonight. Singles his first two times up and a run scored.
Someone surmising that Katie Ledecky has gills.
Perdomo to the belt. Kicks, fires, and it's beaten foul at the plate.
What gets me about the Olympics, Darryl, is that friends I know from back home who aren't really into sports, I mean, not to our degree, I mean, okay, who's into sports to our degree, sports professionals, but, you know, they don't particularly follow baseball or football or basketball or anything about like that, but when the Olympics come around, they are super into it.
It kind of stinks to have to wait 4 years.
Well, that's what makes it so special.
Yeah. I personally am glued to it for 2 weeks. Pitch to heel is slapped on the ground at second. Chavez over to his left. He's got it and throws to first to end the inning. Oh, the Bluefish tack on two, and both will be unearned. Two hits, one error, and two men left. We go to the bottom of the ninth inning. It's Bridgeport 6, York nothing.
Kids today, with Facebook, texting, TV, and video games, seems like fresh air and sunshine are things of the past. Remember playing catch, climbing trees, wholesome backyard fun? Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care remembers. Give them lush grass, healthy trees, the good old outdoors. American is baseball and apple pie. Kids have every reason to stay inside. Don't let your lawn be one of them. Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. World-class care right in your backyard. 717-292-9994.
Savory's Funnel Cakes have brought their delicious delicacies back to People's Bank Park for the second straight year. Be sure to visit their stand on the third base concourse near Arch Street Eats as they offer both regular and pumpkin funnel cakes. Also be sure to check out Savory's Funnel Cake Facial Contest during all York Revolution home games. They offer event catering as well. Give Savory's a call at 717-271-3485. That's 717-271-3485. Savory's Funnel Cakes, York's delicious delicacy for all to enjoy.
Money and business are essential to the strength of a community. So is cheering and celebration and music and fun. That's why York Revolution games, concerts, youth sports, special events, and more happen at a place called People's Bank Park. People's Bank has been serving York County for more than 150 years. Always cheering, always celebrating, always committed to the things that make York County great. And to you having a great time at People's Bank Park. People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Your home for Revolution Baseball. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the ninth, now a 6-0 Bridgeport lead. Right-hander Holden Helmink will make his Bridgeport debut. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. And Connor David will finish the game behind the plate for them as he comes in for Jose Hill. Top of the order for the Revs, who are down six. Travis Witherspoon up first. Helmink was at an open player tryout at Harbor Yard 4 days ago. And it was signed. Last year he was in 12 games at the rookie level with the Arizona Diamondbacks. A Wilmington, Delaware native, but went to high school in Texas and then junior college in Texas. 12th round pick of the Diamondbacks 2 years ago. Just 22 years old, 6'4 righty. 2 years in Arizona's system. All at the rookie level. First pitch to Witherspoon is over for a strike at 92.
How rare is this, Darryl? We've got an all-rookie battery.
Yeah.
In the Atlantic League.
Connor David in his first pro season period out of UConn. Now the 0-1. And a swing and a bounce foul behind the plate on a slider. Revs have only lost back-to-back home games three times all year. That's their longest losing streak at home, too. There's the 0-2, slider away as David collapses on it. In the Diamondbacks system in 2 years, Helmink's ERA was 4.55. 0-2 lifetime record in 26 games. Now out of the stretch, he kicks and fires and missed upstairs, 2-2. Tomorrow night, the fun begins early. Stauffer's Family Fun Fest on the plaza. Post-game fireworks tomorrow, brought to you by the Lube Center. It's Youth Football and Spirit Night here. There's the 2-2. Swinging a tapper toward third, but foul. Get your tickets at YorkRevolution.com, 717-801-HITS, and at the Apple Chevrolet ticket office. You can also get your playoff tickets now as well. Revs will be home Friday, September 23rd for Game 3 of the Division Series. Rally the troops is the promo. 2-2 again, and it missed down and in with Witherspoon jumping back. Count goes full. And the goal is to break the Atlantic League playoff attendance record that night of more than 7,800. That's what we're going for. 3-2, swinging a ground ball sharply to the hole. It's short. Hernandez backhands and a long throw, got spooned by a step. One down here in the bottom of the ninth. Sunday to wrap up the homestand. Cap giveaway presented by Stambaugh Heating and Plumbing to the first 850 fans. And all of our Sunday fun that day, dollar hot dogs as well. Hatfield Quality Meats. Here's Jared Mitchell, who's 1-for-4, a single and a steal. First pitch of the at-bat is down and in. So Witherspoon, with what he did earlier in the week, he's now got 22 steals with York. That's eighth in a season in team history. Mitchell stealing his 19th a couple of innings ago. He's nipping at Witherspoon's heels. Here's the 1-0. That's inside, a fastball. Bridgeport up 6-0 here in the bottom of the ninth. They're trying to end a three-game skid. Starting a stretch where they play 13 of their next 16 on the road. They're a game and a half behind Long Island entering play tonight. 2-0, and that's in tight. And on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard, Long Island at home trails Lancaster 7-5 in the eighth, so if that holds, Bridgeport could be within half a game. Sugarland, as we mentioned, lost at New Britain 3-2, so at worst, the Revs will stay half a game back. Pitch to Mitchell is across for a strike, 3-1.
At Ledecky's final margin in the 803, she won it by 11 seconds. We'll have a screenshot that we found of that in a few minutes on the WOYK Twitter account.
Pitch here is hit high in the air in right field. How deep will it go? Dotel eyeing it up, now backing up only a couple of steps, and he'll make the play. Mitchell just got under it. It's one of those where it was right near the barrel, but he just got underneath. Now the Revs down to their final out here tonight. Joel Guzman will try to keep the game alive. He's 2-for-4 with a double. Helmink ready. And the righty comes home and a swing and a ground ball to second base. A step left is Nunez. He'll gobble it up and sidearm it to first, and that'll do it. Revs drop the opener to the Bluefish. 6-0. Here tonight, a 1-2-3 ninth for Helmink in his Bluefish debut. And for just the fourth time this season, the Revs have dropped back-to-back home games. Held to just four hits tonight as they end up shut out here at home for the first time since June 4th. 6-0 is your final. The Bluefish take game one of the weekend series. Stay tuned. Post-game show follows next.
Hear that? It's the sound of summer. Sound nice? Call Kona Ice. We do it all. Schools, sporting events, parties, both corporate and birthday. You name it, we'll be there. We bring the party to you. If you need a little bit of fun in your life, we're the shaved ice truck for you. Oh, and we fundraise too. This summer, cool down with Kona Ice. Give us a call at 1-800-KONA-ICE or visit us online at www.kona-ice.com. Kona Ice, flavor our world.
What's the simplest, easiest, freest way to get in shape? Walking. That natural walking motion is great for almost everybody, but not every shoe is great for walking.
Flying feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes carries the shoes designed to function best, whether you're out for an invigorating stroll or you're humming along at a serious fitness pace. Walking and fitness shoes that'll do the trick, including a variety of widths and hard-to-find sizes. Walk with name brands like New Balance, Saucony, Brooks, and Accelera. For intense fitness workouts, try shoes from Asics, New Balance, Ryka, Saucony, and 361. Flying Feet's selection is great, and the service is even better. With personal attention, many stores are lacking. Some stores sell shoes. Flying Feet fits them. So take life in stride and do it in style with comfortable walking shoes and fitness shoes from the sportswear specialty store without specialty prices. Flying Feet Sports Shoes.
Flying Feet.
1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, just off exit 18 of I-83.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York.